Hello, all four of you. How's it going? We got a special guest in the back. Lolex.
What's up, dudes?
What's up, man?
What's up, dude?
We're going to hit some corners hard tonight.
Right? Hell yeah. Me and Diego were talking about times we almost crashed our cars right
before this. Yeah. Well, you didn't tell me that. You didn't tell me you almost crashed your car.
I've crashed almost every car I've ever owned. I've crashed. How many cars have I crashed? Shit. I think I totaled one car, and I've been in two accidents after that.
Fuck. Tell me the story. I've only ever been. Let me think. All right. Two incidents. Mm-hmm. One I was rear-ended, and one I was taking a shortcut behind my school. Mm-hmm. Like literally driving like halfway in the woods. And do you know what a bollard is?
No, a bollard.
You ever been in a parking lot and there was like this big cement fucking pole for no reason?
Okay. That's a bollard?
It's called a bollard.
What is that for? Okay, yeah.
It's to keep cars from smashing through shit.
Okay.
I drove, it was like in the woods, the bollard. And my fucking Jetta, or no, my Golf, just scraped the whole side of it. I was like, what
Jesus
was that?
Jesus Christ.
And I get out and there's like yellow paint all down my car.
Dude, you so drove a Jetta. That makes so
no,
much sense.
Volkswagen Golf. Two-door manual 2003. Let me get this super chat and then I want to hear all about your
car crashes. Absolutely.
Car crashes. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Right. OC91 $10. He says, Diego, I listened to your last stream and heard about the family you help out. This is for them. Thank you so much. I guess we got 15 viewers. This stream, and I got monetized without live streaming, just a couple of videos I made, which was cool. And so obviously you can super chat now, and every dollar that gets super chatted will go to the family of a girl that was a big inspiration to me and my family and a lot of people. Thousands of people around the world. She passed away last year, but you know, still like to help the family out. And then I'm in talks with her of trying to find other families that have kids with the same disability that she had. And hopefully, you know, if this thing gets big enough, we'll start helping those families too. The 30% that Google takes, I cover. So if you super chat $100, they get $100. And today at work, I checked the analytics and all that stuff, and we were able to send, just make sure I don't dox anybody. We were able to send today, the first of hopefully many, $267.96, half of which was matched by Rose Paul, which was amazing. So that's where the super chats go. You don't have to super chat, obviously, but it is monetized, and just know that I don't get any of it. Lolex certainly doesn't get any of it.
I don't get shit. I haven't seen a dime of this live stream money.
Me neither. Me neither. I'm crazy? Losing. I'm losing money doing this.
No taxes, but no. I
no taxes watching, and the 30% that I'm covering.
Dude, I was watching old Archie streams yesterday from 3-4 years ago. I don't even look like the same person now. Haven't seen a dime of that money, dude. These motherfuckers got rich off us.
I'm starting to get gray hairs. It's fucking scary.
Dude, got another. I've only got balder, grosser. It's disgusting.
Brody, $10. Thank you. Says for the family fund. Oh, and that just reminded me. I need to go to my Google Sheets. So let me pull that up because that's how I'm keeping track of this stuff. Google Sheets. Let's see this real quick. This is like super high tech stuff.
Yeah, hell yeah. I'm excited to talk about Porsches. I'm doing something at 7:30, so I got about 30-40 minutes. But I want to talk about Porsches at some point.
Okay. So here was the last go around, I guess. So let's get these new ones in there. We'll start a new tab. So we got OC 91, 999. And we got Brody. Brody, is that capitalized? It is. As you can tell, I'm like super anal about shit. But yeah, all right. Thank you guys. America 5726. He says, when do I get mine? It's even got my name. How do you say these Patek references, Lolex? Do you say 5726, 5726, 5611, 5617? Like when I say the 5711, but I say 5164. Like, how do you do it?
I don't even say their names. It's too rich for me. Like, I don't even deserve to.
I was going to make that burn, but you made it yourself.
Yeah, I know it, motherfucker. It's too rich for my blood, my friend. Even holding them, I'm like, yeah, I shouldn't be holding this. This is too much money.
Tell the audience about the car crashes.
I'm trying to think of, like, which one was the best one.
Start with the least best. I want to hear. I want to say.
No. The one that I could think of, which was like where my car was legitimately totaled, was it was raining. I was just on the freeway with my friends. My buddy was driving my car. I wasn't even driving. I was like in the back seat. And
I gotta interrupt you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's so boring. Yeah.
No, because of this.
Hell yeah.
Fucking A, America. 5726, $99.99. Losing money doing this, you said. Eat this $30, Diego. Yeah. Really, that's kind of my way too of I guess that's my, so 30% of everything is from me, technically. So thank you, America. That's awesome. When I sent her the let me see if I can, I'm not gonna show it, but you know, I Zelled it to her today, and let me find this real quick. Chats. Jesus Christ, why is this so hard? Here we go. She said, did you mean to send me money? I just got a notification, right? I explained to her. She didn't know about this, so then I explained how and why. And so she's, big thank you to all you guys. So appreciate it. And we got Daniel Katz. Thank you. Only here for a second. Cheers, Daniel Katz. All right. We got to figure out what 279 Canadian is, because I'm already doing 30%. So 279 Canadian to US dollars. It's 205. Okay, not bad. Thank you, Daniel. All right. Got Buckley in the chat. Tell me about the Porsche now. Start over.
The car crash? Over. I'll tell you that one. When I went off the curb, do you know what the safety dance is? Do you know that song?
No.
The one where it's like, you can dance if you want to, you can leave your friends behind. You know that one?
That's called the safety dance.
Yeah, it's called the safety dance. I was leaving In-N-Out and I was listening to it, and I was like doing the robot with and like singing it, and I went over a curb. I just went ka-ka, and I took a chunk out of the bottom. Like, can you dance if you want to? And then I just like gunk, and I fucking took off a huge chunk out of a $70,000 car. And I was like, well, fuck.
What car was this?
This was the Cayman.
Oh my god!
I was leaving a fucking In-N-Out drive-through, and I ruined my car.
Jesus Christ! In-N-Out.
Yeah. You're gonna leave your friends behind. It's a good song. I couldn't help myself.
Oh fuck! We got another one, Daniel Katz. $13.99 Canadian is $10.29 US. Thank you, Daniel. If I had so here's the thing. StreamYard right now is like, I got like the food stamps version. I can't do anything. Oh, I can only have six people on stream. There's one key. I don't have any banners. There's a nice StreamYard logo up top, but if I had more, I would I don't know, maybe like when people super chat.
I think this is all you need, man. Why do you need more than this? Like, how good is the supercharged StreamYard account? Is it that great?
So what it does is it allows more people to have keys. You can have more people backstage. I can get rid of that StreamYard logo.
Yeah.
We could have like different backgrounds, all that. Put our own music, all that good stuff. So
pretty lame.
But all right, I want to get back to these stories, but people keep super chatting.
Yeah, men without hats, that's what they were called.
Kino Pravda, $10, the best I've ever felt about a super chat.
Oh yeah.
Appreciate it, buddy. Appreciate it, man. That's, yeah. It's, I don't know. It's going to be pretty cool when we can start helping the other families too. So thank you very much. All right. So that's crash number one.
Yeah, that's wrecked. That's not even a crash. It's like a minor fender.
Okay, bender. So you're leaving in and out. Were your hands greasy?
I wasn't even touching the whale. I was like driving with my knees.
All right. When you, when you eat at In-N-Out and then you get into your nice Porsche, you're washing your hands before, right?
Dude, I eat in the car. I don't give a shit. Oh my God. Yeah, I eat in the car. I smoke in the car. I enjoy my car when I have it.
You smoke in your car?
Oh, yeah, I used to. Yeah.
See, I'm still in like the new car phase. So my steering wheel is like almost like, it almost feels like Alcantara. It's like nice and like, and I know what my old one was like after 6 years. It's just like super shiny black.
Yeah.
And I'm like, all right, like I'm washing my hands before I go home from work. I want to keep it new as long as I can. Logan Hall. Yeah. Jeez, Logan Hall. $4.99 for a good cause. I really want to open up and like, what's the word? I want to tell you guys all about this girl at some point, but the sad reality of it is that there are trolls out there. There are people that, I mean, even if I show you a photo of her, you could reverse image search her and immediately find the family. And until I can build some sort of level of trust with the viewers, I'm not going to share that just yet. So, but
I wasn't laughing at you, by the way. I was laughing at America asking if I pissed in the cup holders.
Jesus Christ.
Come on, you guys. You guys don't like a nice cigarette in the car when you're driving on a long trip?
I saw this video. It was like how your girl gets in your car after you've cleaned it.
Oh yeah.
And she like opens the door. Like it's a Porsche, so she opens the door and then she grabs the glass and pushes the glass to open the door. That's the rest funny. Of the way.
Yeah.
When she gets in, her legs are like skirting across the inside of the door. I'm just like, that's my wife. And that's my wife, and that's all my coworkers.
Oh really? Do you ever give them shit? You're like, oh thanks, man.
Dude, I'm like, knock the dirt off your boots, man. What the fuck? And they're like, too low, it's just a car. I'm like, okay. Whatever.
People ain't got no respect. Dude, the 7/8, the cups on D-Smoke, are you British? The cup holders on Porsches suck. Rose keeps asking if I get a lot of speeding tickets. How many speeding tickets have I had?
Have you heard about Rose's speeding tickets?
Oh, what? What about him?
Okay, so he was on, I think, maybe the first stream we did. I can't remember. And he's like, yeah, you know, I get like, I'm kind of known for getting tickets. And we're like, how often do you get a ticket? He's like, I get at least one ticket a year. And me and America, like, one ticket a year? Like I think America said he's never gotten one. In my 18 years of driving, I've gotten two. And Rose thought that, you know, there's like the point system.
Mm-hmm.
He thought once the points like went back to like zero or whatever, that the tickets were forgotten. Mm-hmm. And he was trying to get car insurance. And they're like, fuck you. You have like 35 tickets on your record.
Holy shit. I thought
those went away. It's like, no, they don't.
No, man. You get points on that. That's crazy. All right.
You want to talk Porsche. So let's.
Yeah. To answer your question, Rose. Tickets, I don't know. I think I've had like three or four speeding tickets, and they were never like crazy.
While we're looking at the Cayman, which one are we looking at? So the Lowell X would be like the cheapest one, right? So probably this one.
Yeah, but even then, after like you build it out and the taxes and everything, they start at like 88 now.
You know, the problem when you build these out is it's like, I was doing this the other day, and they're like, would you like leather seats? And you're like, yeah, sure. $6,000.
Yeah.
Then they're like, you know, this really shiny plastic part on the top. Mm-hmm. We can make that leather too. And you're like, yeah, sure. Mm-hmm. And then they're like, you see this part of the door over here? Do you want that leather too? This under part? You're like,
yeah,
sure. And they're like, what about up here? Like, they're all different fucking options.
Yeah.
So it's like, what are you going to do? Like, have half leather interior, half plastic? No. So by the time you add the fucking leather, you've added like 20 grand.
It's a $100,000 car after you do everything. Like, if you want it, then it's $100,000.
And then Lolex. Yeah. Then you're at 100 grand on the build. And you know what? You know what they hit you with next? Do you want a rear view camera?
Yeah, no.
You're like, wait a second. This $100,000 car doesn't have a rear view camera. It doesn't have cooled seats already. Like,
go back to that last photo.
Which
go back to this last
the car?
Yeah, the seats. So you see the back of the seat, right? Like, you see the seats? The back, that's where the engine is, in the back right there.
That's
insane. To access it, they have to take out that entire bay. It's fucking nuts, dude. I remember seeing them service my car when I took it to the dealership to get it serviced. I was doing that. Yeah. I was watching them work on it, and they essentially took apart my car. I was like, Jesus Christ, all that to get to the fucking engine? It's crazy.
Yeah, that's kind of scary.
Yeah.
Because when they're taking it apart, I'm assuming it's like the body coming off.
That entire, you see where the speakers are and the trunk, the flat panel there? They take that entire section off, and then behind the seats, they remove that entire panel. The engine's all back there. It's crazy.
That kind of scares me.
Exactly. That's what I'm telling you. So that's why it's like, you can't like work on these things by yourself, and it's even getting independent people. Even getting independent people, you're just like, you know what? I think I'll pay the extra money and take it to the dealership.
That's kind of why I'm like leaning more towards an old Porsche, because fuck, if your alternator goes out, you can go to AutoZone and install it yourself. LDA, how do you pronounce this? LDA Sense, $499. Thank you very much, buddy.
I think
small G in the house.
Yeah, he wants to know my drive. Yeah, I got a 5 Series BMW at Sean's dealership.
Really?
Yeah, I got it at Sean's dealership. And I met him too, but this was before we even met on Tim's stream.
Oh shit. Did he give you a good deal?
Dude, he gave me an awesome fucking deal. He gave me such a good deal that I can't get out of the car because that's how good of a deal it is.
What was he dressed like?
That's the thing. It's, you know, he wasn't wearing what you would think he'd be wearing. Like, he wasn't wearing like a nice blazer and stuff like that. He was wearing a polo shirt, I remember. And he had an Omega on. I just remember the deal was so good that his sales associate made me go introduce myself to him. He's like, you need to say thank you to my boss. I was like, oh, fuck, okay. So, yeah. Jesus, it's too good. I can't give up the payments on it. It's like it's way too good. So,
give me a second here. This work. There we go. Oh shit, America says it's pronounced Elda Sensei. He's a rapper.
Okay. I guess a rapper. I don't know this. Dude. I don't know this hip hop stuff.
So when I valeted when I was in school, the two best cars, and I drove some shit, right? I drove some pretty cool stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The two best cars I drove, one was an Audi A7.
Yeah.
You know, the slope back?
Yeah, those were great.
White, tan interior, and the wood was non-glossed, like birch wood. Like, you know, what's the wood you see on a beach? It's like super blonde.
Birch. Birch wood.
Is it birch? Oh, yeah, dude. It's birch wood. Fucking amazing. The next car that was my favorite?
No, sandalwood. Sorry, go on.
Something like that. Yeah, it was insane. Yeah. And then the next car that I liked the most was another white BMW. It was just like the standard four-door sedan.
Yeah.
But it was, I want to say it was tan seats too. Wood grain, obviously, but just like super, super solid car, super comfortable, classy. Like, it wasn't loud. I mean, I drove dudes fucking Lamborghinis and what do they call them? Maseratis, Ferraris, like all sorts of shit. They were cool, but like you didn't feel like all right, I'm in a nice fucking solid car. So I like BMWs.
Can I tell you a car I really liked? A car I really, really liked, which people shit on all the time.
Ooh, what is this?
That's the Cayman T. It's like a Cayman S, but like very base modeled. It's very whatever.
I like the color.
Dude, I borrowed my sister's fiance's Maserati Ghibli for 2 days. I really like that car. I really liked it.
A Maserati Ghibli what?
A Maserati Ghibli. It's a sedan for Maserati. People fucking hate it. It's considered the Cayman of the nice car world, like the Boxster. But goddamn, that was such a smooth, fun, like nice sedan car. I liked it.
Dude, this
I would
might
get one,
be,
but they're very shitty.
This might be more in my realm. What's the starting price of the 78?
Yeah.
I like that Carrera T, but getting into six figures like we were talking before stream.
It's like, crazy, dude.
It's like, what am I doing?
Yeah. I can't imagine having like the payment on that thing when I had it was like seven something. Now it would be over $1,000 for a Cayman a month. I'm like, get the fuck out of here, no way. And you have to put money down.
You know, I built a Carrera T and discovered you can put a wing on this bitch.
Yeah.
America was like, take that off. I'm like, why? He's like, you're LARPing. If you have a wing on a Carrera T, you're LARPing that you have a GT3.
I know.
But look how cool it looks. Let me add it real quick.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. I like the... I don't know what the model numbers are, but that year
I don't know.
I don't know the model numbers, but I know the years of these Porsches. And I remember telling you, remember a few days ago, I told you about like the 2010 to 2012 run of those 911s. It's like a modern car, but they look vintage. They have like a vintage look to them.
Where the hell's the wing? Oh, that's window trim. Help me out, Lolux. Oh, here it is.
I can't see anything.
Oh, whoops. Putting a wing on this bitch.
Ugh.
Look at what do you mean? Ugh.
Nah, that's I don't like that.
Without the wing. Yeah, with the wing.
I like it without the wing.
Why are you gay, Lux?
No, dude, I just like a nice basic 911, nothing cleaner.
That's true.
Nothing that's cleaner.
True. Tell me about your other car crashes.
Other car crashes. I'm trying to think which ones were the funny, not scary ones.
Because that one wasn't really a crash, the one you told me.
Yeah, that was I just scratched the shit out of my car. I don't know. I wasn't driving. My buddy was driving my car. We were going to a party. He was driving my car. I'm in the back seat for some fucking reason. And
were you blown?
Yeah, I was blowing someone in the back seat. And then it was raining really heavy, and then someone tapped the back of us, and then we tapped someone in front of us, and then we spun out, and we got hit two or three times, and the car got totaled.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
Berkeley.
That's a Buckley.
Did you just try saying you like Maserati Ghiblis?
Yeah, I do. Maserati Ghiblis, I do. Dude,
do you have a 2-inch peepee?
I don't care. Were you not a fan of Entourage? Because that was like the car of Entourage. That and Escalade.
Oh, dude.
Entourage was a good show.
I get it. You think
you get it now. Yeah, Turtle.
No. You think you're Turtle. I get it.
I am Turtle. I am season one Turtle.
Oh, wait, you're Lolex. You're 31? 32?
Yeah, 32. Yeah.
32. So that show came out what year?
I was in high school when it came out. That's all I remember. 05 or 06?
Yeah. That came out and you were like, this is everything I want.
Exactly. Dude, yes. 100%. I was like, when I grew up, I want an Escalade. I want a bunch of backwards hats. I want all of that. Whatever these guys are doing, I want it.
You were like, yeah.
yeah. I want to bang Jamie Lynn Siegler, or whatever her name is, Meadow Soprano.
Yeah. You know the only show that came close to after Entourage, it was Ballers. You guys ever watch Ballers?
Yeah.
I like that show.
Yeah. I didn't watch that now.
I'm not. As time goes on, I lose about 10% interest in The Rock every year.
Oh, I didn't watch it for The Rock.
Yeah, but he was the main character. I just kind of I used to like him, but I find him in the last couple of years to just be kind of annoying.
I saw a photo of him recently. That dude's skinny as shit.
Right now he's skinny?
The Rock. Oh, yeah. Like, he looks like he's on Ozempic big time.
Nice.
Why has America never... Okay, America has...
Have you never seen Entourage? That's crazy.
Wait a second. If I change my wheels, I can't have the fucking interior I want?
The Entourage... Entourage is like top five favorite shows for me. And it's,
America hasn't seen Entourage. He hasn't seen Sopranos. He hasn't seen Saving Private Ryan. He hasn't seen Saving Private Ryan. Okay.
Fucking listen. I don't know if it's top five shows, but Ari Gold is top five characters.
Oh, it's definitely top five shows for me, at least. I saw Jeremy Piven do stand up at the Laugh Factory in LA, and he was actually pretty funny. You would think he sucked shit, but he was actually really funny.
Which one's Jeremy Piven? I don't know people.
Ari Gold.
Well, Ari Gold, that dude is he's back doing stand up.
He does stand up comedy. Nah, he does stand up comedy. He's been doing it for a while, but
He didn't get canceled?
I mean, he probably got... I don't follow Jeremy Piven, but I saw him on a random night, and he did like a 10-minute joke about Marvel movies and why he's not getting cast. And that was pretty much
it. Oh, yeah, Diego, you're right. He lost like 20, 30 pounds.
Yeah. Let me see if I can... I don't want to lose this page.
You know what, dude?
The Rock 2024.
He probably... The doctor probably went at him and was like, look, if you keep doing steroids like this, you're going to die.
Where did you find the photo? What'd you search?
Instagram. I just went to his Instagram.
Oh, fuck.
I mean, isn't he like 55 years old?
Yeah, and he's on all of the juice, and he's been on it for a long time. And I mean, at that age, it's probably really dangerous.
Yeah, he did that movie, what was it called? Pain and Gain or something like that?
Oh, he was huge.
He was a fucking monster. He was the Hulk. It was crazy.
Yeah. I mean,
I'm trying to see if I can log into my Instagram. Oh, shit. I can't.
There's just no way. Him, John Cena, there's just no way that you can be that size that long. Yeah.
Do I have to search Dwayne?
Here's the thing. Here's what I'd love to know, Buckley, and I'm not accusing you of anything. Jesus. Whoa, that's him?
Yeah, he looks
really looks like me now. I mean,
dude, yeah, that totally. Is literally that is
he literally, looks just like me.
I'll tell you
holy
what that is.
Fuck.
He came off of probably, you know, Trenbolone or something. And that's how fast it goes away.
That's the so doctor scary.
Probably told him like you got about 2 months to live, buddy.
His red blood cell count's probably through the roof.
He looks liver, like Cars and Chrono now.
Liver and kidney markers are probably nuts.
Doesn't he look like Cars and Chrono now, guys?
Kind of, yeah. He's bald and he has glasses.
Yeah. That's kind of the move. If you go, it's a secret move that not a lot of people tell you. When you go bald, get glasses. Get jacked and get glasses.
Have you tested this out a little bit?
I'm going to, for sure.
He lost at least 20 pounds.
That's going to be my look.
We got to go.
You were about to make a joke at me. What were you going to say?
Oh, no, it wasn't a joke at you, but for steroids, you know, I'm assuming you have some knowledge about this, Buckley.
Oh, I have a ton of knowledge.
It's a cycle, right? You're only supposed to do it for, what, 2 to 3 months?
Well,
and then you get off of it.
So the thing is, these guys, the ante has been up ever since, like, the 80s. They went nuts. The 90s was really bad. And a guy like The Rock, you know, and like when you turn like 45, 50 and you're of some wealth, you know, and whatever, you know, you're trying to look after your health. A lot of people get on TRT, testosterone replacement therapy, right? And they usually give you like 100 milligrams a week, 150 milligrams a week tops, right?
Yeah.
These guys are cruising at 400 or 500 milligrams a week. And they're on it for decades.
God damn.
Yeah. Double, triple, quadruple the medical dose. And that's before adding any sort of steroids in. Right? Which, it's not like Arnold, where they were using like Winstrol, D-ball, Deca, right? And they cycle on and off. These guys are on it year round. They're cycling the juice, but they're always on juice. That's why they keep dying. Dude. People in their 40s keep dying. Like every month, there's a new guy in bodybuilding community dead.
Dude, I'm over here scared to take hair medication, and these guys are over here fucking injecting.
Oh, they're taking it. Yeah.
Fuck that.
The way you guys are able to talk about like D-ball, synth, whatever the hell, it's like the same. Like, I'm so lost. It's like when America's talking about, like, stock shit. I'm just like,
well,
what?
D-ball puts on size. D-ball puts on size. Winstrel cuts. I think Deca cuts. Right? They all have different
effects. I need the one that cuts.
No, you don't.
Did you guys ever watch It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's like, I want to get that Jesus on the cross abs.
That gaunt look, yeah.
Yeah. Hold on real quick. We got another super chat from Looking Glass. He says, when are we having an ATL meetup? I'm actually having dinner with somebody
April. With Pam next week.
No, somebody's coming. Somebody in the community's coming April 12th.
Who is Tim G?
No. Sean, yeah, we can do it.
Sean.
Yeah, Sean's coming. Oh, Sean, Masters. Really? Sean's coming for the Masters the week. Oh shit! So yeah, I'll probably see Sean. I think it's the week of the Masters, the 8th. So,
are you going, Diego? Are you going to the Masters?
I might. We'll see how the allergies are doing. I told Sean I would, but it's hitting me pretty hard. Did you see the photo of my car, Lolex?
No, but I do know that the pollen situation in Atlanta is outrageous.
Let me show you this. This is the day after. Where's this fucking photo?
Oh, you got sinus issues?
It's not sinus.
I've never understood that. I don't get it. Yeah, I don't get allergies, but
dude, this is my rear view. Well, this is one of my mirrors the day after I cleaned my car.
Yeah, fuck all okay. That.
You breathe that in.
You breathe it in and it gets in your eyeballs. Look at this shit. It's 3D.
Yeah, that doesn't even sound like allergies. It sounds like you're being attacked.
Yeah.
You are being attacked.
Yeah, that's so, not allergies.
Just, but here's the thing. Going to the Masters, that's what I've never gone because it's always during this season.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, the cut grass and all that, you're going to have a problem.
Yeah. But Looking Glass, next time I talk to Sean, I'll see. I don't know where he's staying. If he's staying in the city, absolutely. The week of the 8th, let's do something.
Dude, so awesome. Funny. America just gave us the formula to do a cycle. Winstrel, Avinar.
Yeah. Thank you.
Just naming a different one. Look,
okay.
There's so many people on juice, and they pretend like they're not, and it's just so absurd.
Like,
so absurd.
Testosterone's like the new thing now, right? That's the thing that everybody's on. You go get tested for it.
There's people that would argue that testosterone's not even compared to what's out there, testosterone's not even a steroid at this point.
Yeah. Well, who was I talking? I was talking to Mathis about that in Vegas. He was like, you just go to a doctor, get tested for T. They say, oh, you're a little low.
They'll give it to you.
They give you a deodorant
range,
stick.
The thing is, the range is so absurd. Like, the range of what is accepted is 250 to 800, like level two. So, if you're at 251, they'll be like, you're fine. And if you're at 790, they'll treat the guy at 799 and the guy at 251 the same.
My God.
So it's like,
isn't that stuff like, that's not supposed to be long term, right? Like, no, if you get testosterone.
It's testosterone replacement therapy. So you're going on it for life.
Oh, fuck. And if you stop, you're screwed.
If you stop, you fall back to where you were, and if you do it long enough, like if you do testosterone for like a year or more, 2 years or more, you may never recover. Like it's gone, it's done. Like you're on it. Like every single WWE, every single celebrity, every single bodybuilder, they're going to be on TRT forever.
Jesus Christ!
For some reason, I'm just thinking how funny it would be if I got obscenely jacked in my 30s. Just got like a little fucking.
We would look at it if you're.
That's what I'm trying to do. It's not working.
Fuck that. No way.
It's not working. It's not working. No way. Yeah. I've hit the plateau. I'm like the Roadrunner. Vimal Nair. Vimal.
The legend himself, Vimal.
them all. Love to have them all on the panel. $2 says congrats on the new channel, enjoying the content. Yeah, so I've had this channel for a fucking over 11 years, maybe more. And I just recently started uploading some videos, and I'm not trying to blow smoke at my ass, but some of them kind of got traction, and then it got monetized. So trying to use the most of it. What is $2 Canadian to like US dollars?
40 cents maybe?
What is
negative a dollar?
Canadian negative. Negative. Should we be sending them all money? Do I owe them all money for the super chat? It's a dollar.
I guess he's in Canada, but he belongs in Texas.
Yeah, dude. Brass balls over here.
I think it's a dollar 47.
Vimal for president.
He's trapped in Canada.
Yeah.
Vimal, these all go to a charity. So.
What charity does this go to, Diego?
Buckley Foundation.
Buckley.
No, it goes to the Human Fund. It goes to the Human Fund. You've heard of that?
No, I haven't.
It's a Seinfeld reference.
Okay.
George is like, I guess he didn't buy Christmas presents for anybody at the office. And he's like, shit, I got to buy presents or I'm going to look like an ass. So he writes everybody a letter. Like, instead of a gift, I donated money on your behalf to the Human Fund. Money, yeah, money for humans. And everybody thought, oh, it's such a great thing. And they all find out it's fake. Brody.
Yeah. Hello, Brody.
And but to answer your question real quick, Lolex, there was a girl that lived close by that I've told you about her.
Yeah, you told.
Okay. So it all goes to that family, and we're in talks. I sent her the first payment today, and we're gonna see if we can find other families who have the same issues.
Very nice.
The Human Fund. Appreciate it. What's up, Brody? I guess I'll turn the camera on too.
I heard you talking about steroids, so I thought I'd hop on. And laugh, yeah, Buckley, spread rumors about me.
This is the steroids. Well,
Brody's 61 and he's got a 22-year-old's body, so I have some fucking questions, all right?
Steroid talk, guys. You want to get into some steroid talk?
No, I'm not that big. It's hard for me to put on size because I'm 61. I mean, I'm only.
Yeah, but you're shredded. Fucking guy's got 12. Listen.
Yeah. Well, no. Not quite, but yeah.
Here's a question. Was Arnie on steroids?
Oh, yeah. 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 But
he was on, like, horse tranquilizer shit.
Yeah,
like,
what kind of prehistoric shit was this guy taking?
No. What Arnold was taking back then is, like, 10 to 20% of the dose of what they take now.
Jesus Christ.
So that is true. Like, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man, that's awesome.
I've done, like, substantial research on this. Like,
I thought you were about to admit to something, Buckley. Like, substantial.
I go through phases of obsessions. So, like, I'm at the end of my watch cycle right now. Mm-hmm. But there was, like, a working out cycle. So in that working out cycle, I did some deep homework on this shit. And now there's so much information available. He was using like 150 milligrams of test a week, and he was using base steroids that the Russians came out with.
This was like the Wild West of steroids. Like, nobody knew the limits, and he just like.
Well, it was actually safer. They were legal. So he was getting pharmacy steroids that were legal, but they were not nearly as powerful as the ones now. The ones now will kill you.
Let's see how that ended up for him, Arnold 2024.
I mean, he's probably pretty fucking good. He's almost 80.
Yeah, he's an old man, dude.
If Buckley committed to like a steroid cycle the way he did to watches, he'd be on a different steroid like every other week.
That's true. Oh my god. Small G asks, does it affect your penis?
depends on the steroid.
Yeah,
some of them the dick won't go down. Some of them won't go up. You just got to pick.
Yeah. Yeah, it depends if you're a soy boy or not.
No, it depends on the juice. Like, there's a thing. One of the side effects with Deca is called Deca dick. Your dick doesn't Deca work. Dick.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Oh, man. Deca dick.
Deca dick. Damn. Is a bit. It's a real problem.
Damn, my photo looks good.
Who else was a fucking steroid monster?
Sly.
I was about to say.
But he still looks good.
Steroids.
I don't think he took anything crazy, to be honest with you.
Well, this dude definitely did.
Well, he was always sort of a like a big guy, but not defined, like for the first Rocky. And then he got shredded. So he kind of shrunk in size, but he got shredded.
Yeah, so, this is Rocky 1, right?
Yeah, Rocky 1, that wasn't steroids, right? He's just a big that was Italian guy.
Yeah.
Rocky 2. Out. Look at this.
That's Rocky 3. That's Rocky 3. That's Rocky
3. Yeah, there you go.
So what happens here is he becomes friendly with Franco Colombo, who was Arnold's training partner.
Mm-hmm. Right. Oh, that and dude, the little short guy? That little short dude?
Yeah, they get him on the juice in Rocky 3, and he does not come off again until present day.
Yeah.
Did you ever hear what's that movie?
So he if you follow him like through his movies in the early 2000s, he actually gets on human growth hormone and he puts on like 30 pounds.
Jesus, really?
Yeah, type in Rocky Balboa body. Rocky 6.
Oh, Balboa. You're talking Balboa. So,
the one with six?
Rocky 6 or Rocky Balboa body. Type this in.
Yeah, that's the one where the trainer's
you see how much fucking bigger he is?
Yeah, he's like, you're too far. He's got that chest. You can't run.
That chest thing.
Yeah.
He's huge, though. He's like, wide.
That's growth hormone.
That's the Joe Rogan effect.
Yeah. He literally looks like a tall Joe Rogan there.
He's got that dune worm coming out of his stomach.
what the fuck?
He said his head grew.
Yeah, well, that's what happened to Barry Bonds, right? Yeah. I mean, look at him when he was with the Pittsburgh Pirates, and then look how big his head got when he was with San Francisco.
Dude, I'm telling you.
Your head doesn't get bigger naturally when you're in your 20s.
Dude, I'm telling you, I've seen Joe Rogan. He walked right by me. That motherfucker, as buff as he is, his head is massive.
Yeah.
Did you know Mathis thinks that two of him can beat up Joe Rogan?
Yeah, I don't think so. Okay, can we talk through this? Because I had this conversation with Diego.
Let me just read the super chat and then
we'll talk through this.
Dive deep into this. Daniel Katz, 279 Canadian, 208 American. I think Sly survived. He did. Thank you for the super chat, Daniel.
So the other thing too,
we're gonna pull up a photo of Joe Rogan here.
Yeah, pull it up, and I want to tell. Go Buckley. Go. Sorry.
Sly takes human growth hormone up until one of the Rambo movies, but he gets caught. He gets caught at the airport in Asia with human growth hormone, and then I guess from embarrassment, he comes off, and he loses like 20 pounds immediately.
Okay. See this. I understand what you're doing right now, Diego, showing this, but this is not going to give you the full picture of Joe Rogan. Like, you have to go to his Instagram. I've walked by him. I swear to God, Diego, he's my height. He is my height.
So the thing is, Joe Rogan is a black belt in jiu-jitsu.
Oh, for sure.
Mathis is only a brown belt.
Mathis is a brown. Joe's black belt is a Gracie black belt. I don't know what Mathis's is. And Joe Rogan was also a competitive Taekwondo kickboxer. So the thing is, if there's two Mathis's, the first one's getting kicked and is out. And the second one is getting choked out, most likely.
Yeah, the first Mathis's liver is exploding.
The first Mathis's taking a kick to the face and he's out. The second one is most likely getting choked.
Okay, but here's the thing, though. Joe Rogan would have to kill the first Mathis. He would have to kill the first one.
No, he just has to inebriate him. Dude.
I don't think so.
Mathis is like, he's a pit bull. He's brown belt. But when Joe Rogan punches him or kicks him in the ribs, he's just going, oh, geez. And then the other Mathis is going, oh, shit.
Listen, it's over. I'm going to stand by this. And Diego said that this is no shot. But I think two Diegos and two Lolex could take down Joe Rogan. Four of us, we can fucking bring him down. Let me add this. Two of me are going to die in this situation. I've accepted this. Two of them are going to die.
Dude,
Diego has to finish him off. That's what it is. One around his neck and the other just going crazy.
You're assuming you get your hands on. The thing is, you know where you're going to lose, Lolex? You know where you and Diego are going to lose? Your adrenaline and cardio are going to go inside of 30 seconds.
Oh, yeah. It's got to be quick. It's a quick attack. All of us on him at once.
And then you're going to be like,
look at his neck, Lolex.
I'm telling you, Diego, I've been right next to him. I understand.
Jump on this guy's back. I know he's short, but.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
Here's the thing. Beyond size, this guy knows how to strike. We do. Yeah. He's going to strike us, and we've never experienced a strike like that before. And we're going
to
get
I'm ready to die.
Anywhere he hits us in our body, our thigh, we're going down.
So as far as hand-to-hand combat, wrestling, jiu-jitsu, and then just combat, I think the most deadly man on earth is Tim Kennedy.
Really?
Did you watch that Tim Kennedy episode?
Of course I did. I fucking love Tim Kennedy. Tim Kennedy.
I've always loved Tim Kennedy.
Tim Kennedy might be the most dangerous man on the planet.
Yeah. That was crazy. I didn't know about that fight that he got robbed.
Yeah. With the Cuban fucking
with Mathis.
With the experiment, because nobody knows how old that guy is, and nobody, like, there's rumors that he was literally created in a Castro lab, and it's like kind of proven.
So, Mathis, this guy was fighting for the fight before the belt fight. He knocks the fuck out of this guy right as the bell's ringing. And I think you have like...
Joel Romero.
Yeah. You got a certain amount of time to stand up. And after that 15 seconds elapsed, like, the dude didn't stand up. So he's like, that's it. I won. Technicality. It's over. And they gave that dude like another minute and a half to just like keep sitting on his stool and like get his composure and all that. And then Tim Kennedy gets knocked out like in the next 10 seconds.
So... In my previous life before streaming with Tim Wright and losing my life to streaming and the watch community, I would watch a lot of other YouTube channels and different podcasts. And Tim Kennedy, I guess at one point he bought a Rolex. Well, he did. He bought a Rolex series, and it was a two-tone bluesy, like one of the ones from, what do you call it? From like the 90s, early 2000s, the pre-ceramic?
Yeah, neo-vintage. Yeah.
And it was... fucking tiny. He's got bigger wrists.
Yeah.
He's got bigger wrists than me, this guy.
Yeah. Isn't it crazy when you see that? Like, you see guys where they're fucking, even modern Submariners just look small on them. You're just like, Jesus, dude, are you human?
Well, I have a theory about this. So I have a theory about this. And I tried putting it in our group chat being funny, but I was also being serious. All these guys that are in special forces and all these different guys like the Joe Rogans and stuff, all of them deadlift and they deadlift heavy.
Oh, for sure.
And that will make your wrists and forearms will get bigger. All of them have wrists and forearms. And it turns out of the 16 people we have in our group chat, there's three or four that all deadlift heavy and all of us have big wrists.
So you know Jocko, right? You guys know Jocko?
Jocko's wrist is enormous.
Okay, this is a guy named Drago next to him. This guy was a Polish refugee that fled like a communist prison in Poland, came to the States, became a SEAL at like the age of like 32 or some shit.
Yeah.
This guy was a fucking monster.
All of these guys, huge. When you go through that type of training, there's some sort of hex bar or regular deadlift thing. There's farmer carries. There's all sorts of shit, right? And that just makes your wrists bigger. I don't know what I can't.
Yeah.
Every single person I know that has followed some sort of athletic upbringing or has gotten involved in something like that, they all have the forearms and the wrists that they're all 7.5 inches are up. So I was joking with Diego and Small G. I'm like, follow this program and we'll add a half inch on. He's like, nah, man, it's genetics.
It is genetics. It's
definitely not. Nah.
Dude, there's too many photos of like naked dudes on the stream.
Are Oh, that's so funny.
We can keep talking about it, but I'm gonna put the car back on.
I think we're not forced to talk about watches here. We could talk about
That's true.
We could be like Tim and just talking about 4P and bezels for fucking 8 hours a day.
Diego,
you know what I've heard real quick before we get off that? Yeah. The guy that shot Bin Laden apparently did it. It's a big thing.
Did what?
Huh?
Did what? Deadlift? This, probably.
No, this guy went around saying he shot Bin Laden. Yeah. And all the people that are chirping that were on the mission are like, no, the fuck he did it. And now he's now people are like analyzing every interview he's ever done. It's bad.
Yeah, I always thought it was weird. There's a couple of weird things about that. Number one, why the fuck did they take the body and dump it in the ocean? Okay, that's strange. Number two, you can't come out and talk about this stuff. It's all classified. You can't
come out. That's true. Yeah, that's true.
It just doesn't make any sense to me. And this guy's doing like speaking engagements for tens, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars. It's a little bit strange.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I don't know. It's a little bit. So remember I told you I go through my phases. During one of my phases in fitness, this was shit. This has got to be like 7 years ago at this point, 6 years ago. I did like a 3-month membership at a CrossFit gym just to try it because CrossFit was super hot at that point. And there was two Navy SEALs that did CrossFit in there, two of them. First time I ever met a real Navy SEAL, because in New York, nobody's a fucking Navy SEAL. Like, they don't come from New York. They come from Texas, right? So they were like, yeah, nobody likes that guy, and we're kind of pissed, and we also aren't really sure if his story is legit. This was 6 years ago.
Yeah. Yeah, apparently he probably did shoot Bin Laden. They all shot Bin Laden in the chest. Like, that's what everybody says, is once he was dead, they all went in and pumped a few rounds in the chest. But he clearly says that he shot him twice in the head. And I've seen a lot of interviews where they're like, that's not what happened. But anyway, this guy here, Drago, he's got a really good interview on, what's that? The Jocko podcast.
So, Diego, the thing about that, too, what's a little bit weird, I don't know if you noticed, because you follow Sean Ryan, right?
Mm-hmm.
All of Sean Ryan's guests that were actually in the field and killed people, they all have some sort of mental health issue afterwards, right? They all kind of struggle. That guy doesn't seem to have any sort of anything, right? Like, there's
you're talking about, what's his name? They call him Red. The ginger.
I'm talking about the guy who shot Bin Laden. He doesn't seem to have any sort of there's no PTSD, there's no mental, there's no issue with talking about what happened, right? All these other guys, they all have a problem afterwards.
So what I've noticed is the guys that have made it to Team 6 or like the development group, those guys always seem fine. Those guys are on like a completely different level. And I don't know if they just got overly exposed to shit, or if they're just like, they won't show that they're fucked up. But I don't know. Yeah. Like, yeah, these guys really got fucked. But this guy here, Lolex, again, he's Polish, right? So he's like, he kind of talks like this, right? I'm not Polish American, I'm American. Like, that's how he talks. Exactly. He said when he was in Iraq, you know, they would take down a house and they're trying to interrogate these guys. And they're like, Drago, they're not talking. He's like, give me 2 minutes with them. And he's like, I had a course. It was called Drago's Accelerated English Training Course. Pretty much you take them in a room and beat the fuck out of them. And they'd start speaking English.
Yeah. Yeah. There are dudes out there that have an extra, I don't know, there's an extra layer there where they're just fucking.
Oh, Jesus.
We're lucky that we don't live in times where people would just come into your village and kill everybody and take whatever they want, right?
Yeah.
Because
you
wouldn't have Zuckerberg running a company if you could still do that.
Speaking a little bit about watches, Sean Ryan is like, when he started his show, it was pretty much just the black, black, black. That's all he had.
Yeah.
I've seen him with like solid gold, yellow gold subs, sky. Blueberries, Sky Dweller.
Yep. Yep. He's got a blue, he's got a blueberry and he's got a solid yellow gold Sky Dweller.
Yeah. We need to get him on the show.
Oh yeah, definitely.
He's got the number four podcast in the world right now.
Oh, it's incredible. And yeah. what I like about his show is Lolex, you've probably never seen. I don't know if you've seen it, Brody. No.
But when he'll have pop up on Joe Rogan, I just skip the episodes. Like this.
He'll have
PhDs. I'm like, no thanks.
He'll have SEAL Team 6 guys, he'll have CIA guys, whoever, right? Special recon, recon forces, whatever. And they'll be like, that was probably the worst day of my life. And he'll sit back and he's like, tell me about it in detail.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
But he was a SEAL too, right? So
yeah,
he'll be like, do you remember your first kill? And like the guy's like, yeah, I'll never forget that. He's like, let's get into it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's like, all right, let's get into it.
Right. And they're like, okay, well, you know, the guy appeared out of the bush and I shot him. Where'd you shoot him? in the chest. What caliber round did you shoot him with? And it's like, but I don't know. It's the stuff that we want to, I think, strangely enough, it's the stuff we want to kind of hear. And I think it's the stuff these guys need to say out loud. So I don't know if you guys have ever experienced any really difficult shit in your lives, but saying it, like once you actually say the words, it's kind of healing in a way.
No way, dude. I pull a Don Draper. I just fucking stuff it down in my stomach.
You're going to die of a fucking heart attack when you're 40 if you do that.
Dude, I'm gonna die of fucking stomach cancer this week.
But I think a lot of these guys go on a show knowing that, like, I've had all this shit pent up in me since I got out, and like I just need to let it out. My buddy, my coworker, who was in an IED, big explosion in Afghanistan, I think he's in a podcast now, and he said part of the reason starting the podcast was he wanted to tell his story so that he only had to tell it once, right? And if you wanted to hear it, you go listen to it.
You know who's a badass on the show? Eric Prince.
Eric Prince
was Blackwater.
Oh, dude. Yes. This guy was epic. This guy right here, just fucking leaning back the whole time.
The founder of Blackwater. And for what, if the fucking people watching don't know what that is, that was just hired mercenaries for these guys made hundreds of thousands of dollars a year doing mercenary work for the U.S. contracted by the U.S.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, this guy,
yeah.
I think he was, wasn't he close to like a billionaire or something? Like he was like, yeah, like this is a motherfucker, right? Like this is the guy that they make movies about.
But in reality, what they were doing was they were backfilling roles that the military didn't have the people for. So it was like, we need to get supplies from Bagram to this outpost, or we need to escort Iraqi government officials. Well, we can't fucking just let a squad of Marines go do this shit. And a lot of the guys that Blackwater had were former Delta SEAL, Force Recon, all that kind of shit. And they were looking for employment too. You know, they're trying to get jobs as security guards making 30 grand a year. This guy's like, hey, you want to go over there and make six figures? They're like, fuck six, yeah,
figures, dude. Like 300, 400 grand.
Like, yeah. Like, absolutely, I'll go to fucking Mogadishu or wherever you send me. Yeah. But they got into some weird shit in Iraq. There was some really strange stuff happening over there. But yeah. Vimal, tell your wife you need to go take a shit and jump on the stream. I'm going to drop the link.
Also tell her that you have to sell the house and move to the U.S.
This is the guy, by the way, Buckley, that said he thinks, I don't know if I'm going to bring this up. He's talking about taking over a certain continent. Remember we talked about that a little bit?
There's a lot of, so.
Because if we don't, another country will.
So that is, yeah, you're not a continent. You're talking about a country, right?
No, I'm talking about the continent.
Oh, I know what you're talking. Okay.
I'm on the private show. I don't know if we're going to talk about this. Probably won't.
I'm thinking of a different guy having a different conversation about.
But this is the guy that said we need to go and liberate this entire continent.
Yeah. Yeah. Well,
Eric, or not Eric Prince, Vimal Nair. Is it Nair or Nair? $5 Canadian super chat. Thank you, Vimal. He says Eric Prince is a true American legend. They got him to do the real tough work, but he was a fall guy for political reasons. That's true. He was also a SEAL. Not for very long, but he was certainly a SEAL. What's $5 to 368? Yeah. Oh man.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on private mercenary armies?
I mean, I like, you're talking to the wrong guy because I like all that shit.
You like the movie
I'm the guy that says if there's a monster, just make sure he's on my team.
Yeah.
And I know that's gonna ruffle some fucking feathers, but that's the way I roll, okay?
Private mercenaries.
What happened to Lolex?
He has to be, he says.
Where the fuck are you going on a Tuesday night?
He's got to be. He said he has to be up at 7 a.m.
Oh, wow.
Dude, you know what time it is? You know what time it is where he is, though?
Yeah, it's like fucking 7:30.
Yeah, what the fuck, Lolex?
Do you know what he's going to do, Diego?
What's he going to go do?
He's going to go on the balcony. He's going to smoke a fat joint. That's what he's going to do.
Probably.
That's what he's going to do. And then he's going to order like Taco Bell or whatever the fuck people in California eat when they're high.
Jesus. And then
he's going to watch like Seinfeld.
I don't know if he watches Seinfeld.
Oh, Lolex definitely
watches. No, he's been deep into what has he been into? He's been deep into Mad Men. Maybe if we do some Mad Men talk, that'll get Lolex back on.
No, he's going to play Todd. That's what they said.
Lolex thinks he's Don Draper now. That's what he thinks. He's always like sending me Don Draper memes. Some of them are pretty funny.
Mad Men is a show where for 6 seasons nothing ever happened, but everything happened.
Yeah, dude, it was amazing. I saw it live when it came out, and then I saw it again years later, the whole thing through. And it was like watching a completely new show.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's going on with this Key Bridge? I heard about this at work today. Key Bridge came down so fast. I know the freighter was huge. What's going on with this?
Oh yeah, that's fucked up. Did you see that?
Is it actually a bridge, or is it the bridge of a ship?
Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore. A ship collided into one of the pillars holding it up, and the whole thing collapsed with cars driving on it into the water at night. Just go to Key Bridge. So it's
wait,
not,
what?
Yes, it's bad. It's really bad.
Cars. Ooh.
Because it collapsed almost instantly after hitting it.
Oh, dude.
Yeah, it's fucked. It's fucked.
Oh, they hit the fucking
thing.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So they didn't. Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's bad. It's really bad.
I thought maybe they had just like clipped it.
No.
Wait. So how many?
A lot.
What was that song Lolex said he was listening to when he hit the curb?
I don't know what that was coming.
Can you imagine Lolex driving his new Porsche on this bridge?
The thing is, I would assume that the fall.
Oh, hold on. OC91 says apparently no cars. A ship's mayday call led police to close the bridge. 8 road workers were on it. 6 dead. Oh, fuck. Well, shit, if they called to close the bridge, why were there workers on the bridge?
Yeah. Jeez. You like being so from there, it looks like that's, I don't know, 50 feet off the water, right? From this angle. But those container ships,
they're huge.
Huge. That bridge is probably 200 feet off the water, 300 feet. So that fall, it's over. You're done. You're done on that fall. It's done.
Small G says it's a important bridge.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Could you imagine the traffic? now? Because all they have is, I think Baltimore, all they have is that tunnel.
Besides the bridge,
they have a tunnel.
I need to see what Baltimore looks like in the map. Just making sure I'm not doxing Diego address or your address to Baltimore. It's like, all right, so the key bridge, I'm assuming it's this.
No,
that's the tunnel.
I've been through that tunnel.
This, right here.
Yeah.
No, Hanover Street Bridge.
That.
Oh, Baltimore Harbor Tunnel.
Where the fuck is
it? I bet this is it. Oh, here it is, Francis Key Bridge. So, it's the first bridge from the fucking... Ooh!
That's a problem.
Look what America said. $81 billion port shut down indefinitely. Holy fuck. Can you imagine if you had like a car coming or some shit? Oh, Small G says zoom out. Small G, jump on the panel. You know.
Nothing happened to the ship. Oh, I mean, I'm sure it has damage. The container.
No, but I'm saying the port's shut. Like, America's saying the port is completely shut down for who knows how long. Because nobody can get in or out. And then imagine when they're having to rebuild this bridge. That's going to
take forever.
That's going to disrupt the port as well. Jeez.
But how many years is it going to take to rebuild a bridge?
Well, let me go back to the video. So let's see. Okay, so this is definitely needs to be rebuilt. Any kind of reinforcement there.
The whole thing, dude. The whole thing's totaled.
Yeah, I mean, but like not the good thing, but I don't know what this is called on a bridge.
Yeah.
But the part that, Brody, do you want to come back on, by the way? Give me a thumbs up if you do. Okay, cool. Yeah, like I think this is called a trussle maybe, or, you know, there's a bunch of concrete down here that's reinforcing. This
below the earth, yeah.
This is fine. That's the stuff that takes a long time.
This is our fourth largest port in the country.
Jeez. Do you know Savannah is like the second largest port?
No shit.
I think so. I was just in Savannah a couple weekends ago and I hung out with Rob, this guy. Pretty good time.
Yeah, I don't know. It's pretty fucked. There's been a lot of crazy shit going on lately.
Damn. Yeah, I didn't know what people were talking about. When they said the bridge collapsed and they were talking about a ship, I was like, are they talking about like the bridge on the ship collapsed? Like, okay, that's kind of strange.
So apparently the ship lost power and then it couldn't steer, couldn't navigate.
Could they not like tugboat that bitch? Well, I guess
it happened in four minutes.
Oh wow. Yeah, you can't do anything.
Move through the water.
Dead. Kyle D says, why didn't it drop anchor? I don't know. Crazy, man. I never realized how close Baltimore is to Philly, is to New York. I didn't even know Philly was next to New Jersey.
Well, it's close to DC.
What the hell? This whole thing's New Jersey? By the way,
Baltimore is like an hour and a half from DC. An hour.
Is this entire thing New Jersey?
Yeah.
Why can't you see my mouse? This thing.
So New Jersey's weird because
I thought New Jersey was over here.
It is. But it goes up high. New Jersey, you can get through the whole thing though pretty fucking quick. What? Like if you're on 95 on Jersey, you can go from top to bottom in like 90 minutes.
I didn't realize how big New Jersey was.
Yeah, it's big.
Oh,
big,
Small G.
Stupid state.
What's up, though. Small G?
It is.
What's up?
New Jersey has a lot of stupid shit going on, okay? Number one, the parking spots are backwards. Number two.
Wait, what does that mean? What does that mean, the parking spots
are backwards? So the parking spots are literally fucking backwards at a lot of the rest areas and stuff.
What do you mean backwards? we gotta find a rest area.
Instead of regular head-in parking, they're slightly slanted in the opposite direction. It's retarded. The other all thing.
Right, so there you go. See, hold on.
New Jersey.
Where's this exit? I want to see this. All right, so you turn into here, and then you pull in. They want you to do a U-turn. That's for buses.
You cannot fucking feel the gas by yourself.
Yeah, if you want to turn left there, you're fucked.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. You can't fill the gas yourself. You can only make, what is it, small g? You can only make right turns?
Yeah, only main right turn. And all the store.
Wait a second. Hold on.
Time out. What do you mean you can only make right
turns? Only right turns in the entire state?
Yes.
In the whole state? You can't, there's no left-hand turn lines?
Only on like streets, like residential, any sort of major highway, any sort of major road, you can only make right turns.
So if I'm this dude and this I'm trying to deliver.
This wouldn't be considered a major road.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
You're talking about like your 55 mile an hour roads.
No, and a lot of intersections too.
Jesus
every Christ. Single exit, every single exit has a small toll of like, what is it? Small 25 cents.
Yeah, what? It's crazy. It's the most dangerous intersection is in New Jersey.
Yeah.
So wait, when you get off on an exit, like let's say I'm driving on, what is this? That's not a major highway. Where's it? What's the major highway in New Jersey? Like 295?
One, number one.
Yeah.
Where's one? Let me find one.
There's a lot of stupid shit going on in Jersey.
Where the hell is one?
That dangerous intersection is probably a bunch of out of towners trying to make left hand turns because they don't know any better.
Wait, so if I get off on this exit, I got to pay money?
Oh, that's a Jersey Turnpike. You know, if you drive Jersey Turnpike all the way to Philadelphia, you need $50 toll.
Yeah.
Fuck. There's $50? Dude, $50?
Oh, $50 toll.
Every single exit has a small toll.
Super crazy.
Rosetta says New Jersey is a Gerard Perrigo of states will never amount to anything good. Wow. I did not realize how big New Jersey was. I literally my entire life thought this little sliver here was New Jersey.
So that's it. New Jersey's weird too. So see that section you're looking at right there?
Mm-hmm.
That's a mixture of basically New Yorkers, then you have Chinese people, and you have really bad ghettos. And then when you get to mid-Jersey, it starts getting south.
This is mid-Jersey?
Yeah.
Like Trenton?
Yeah, you start getting into like...
Trenton.
Like white trash. Starts getting white trashy real quick.
Trenton is the capital, but you don't want to be there.
No.
So where do you like in a general sense in Jersey? Where do you live?
What's that?
What part of Jersey? Or you live in Philly, right?
I live in the Philly, but it's suburbs, so I'm close to Jersey.
You sound like a Willow Grove kind of guy.
Willow Grove?
No. So yeah, when you go to New York,
I live nearby the Kino Prusa area, so.
Yeah. So when you go to New York, you drive into Philly and then you take like a train up here?
No. I drive to Princeton and I take a train in.
Okay.
You know, I'm supposed to drive to Trenton, but you know, Trenton, you don't want to park anywhere nearby that in 15 miles.
You don't want to wear an FP Jordan in Trenton.
That's the other thing. No. The trains in Jersey are pretty rough. They're old. They're really fucking old. I was shocked because I took the train in Jersey once. I was shocked at how old everything is.
What do you guys think about Chicago? Is the Miracle Mile still dangerous?
I was just there. I grew up in Chicago.
I live in Chicago for 6 years. I
love
Chicago.
I fucking love it. So I love Chicago. Me and the wife went twice within 3 months because we liked it so much. And everybody's like, God, so dangerous. I'm like, dude, I'm not going over here, you know?
Like, no, the dangerous part of Chicago is the south side. Everything in Chicago in the loop, it's good.
Small G, the West Side's worse.
The West Side's bad too.
It's like any other city that's so body of water. The further away you get from the water, the worse it is.
Exactly. If you stay near the lake.
Look at this fucking city, man. God.
That's the Wrigley building right there. That one right there.
Yeah. This is a great. We had a really good time.
There's
Summer Chicago is beautiful.
Do you know when you do the river tour? If you notice that there's not a sign on any building except for one.
Keep going. Yeah. I noticed that already. Yep.
It's there the unwritten rule in the city. You're not supposed to put your lecture name on the building. That's the only one who did it. You do the river architectural tour and it stands out like a sore thumb. It's hilarious.
Isn't there a building on this street that has slabs of like different pieces of like, God, Jesus Christ. Like it's got pieces of like the Great Pyramid of Giza and like the Berlin Wall. I think it might be. Is it this building? Rose might know. I think.
I like.
Yeah, it's this building. This building. So this building, everywhere when you walk outside, like this might be from the Colosseum. This might be from.
So that's the old Sun Times building.
Yes. Yeah. So they got a bunch of really cool stuff.
It's like the local radio station that carries the Cubs and the Blackhawks and the White Sox. So that's the old Sun Times building.
Yeah. Yeah, so if you're ever in Chicago, check that out. It was pretty interesting. And I remember they had, I don't know. See, I live in Atlanta where everything's made out of drywall, like literally. So to see a building like this made out of like limestone or granite, it really, I don't know. Gets me all excited.
Yeah.
But yeah, we never felt when we were in Chicago, we never felt like we were in danger or anything.
It's not.
I wasn't out buying Subway at 4 a.m. in the wintertime.
No, yeah, you wouldn't do that. But
with Jesse.
Yeah. if you stay in the loop, and you know, you stay not too far off Michigan Avenue, you're fine.
Yeah. Subways are. Subways are not a great place to be.
You guys remember that Jesse Smollett?
So most of Chicago's subways are above ground. I'm not saying they're not dangerous.
You don't want to fly to the Midway Airport in the midnight and then take the public transportation to downtown. It's pretty dangerous that way.
Never fly into Midway.
Yeah, never. Maybe
from the East Coast you could get a nonstop flight. If you're going into the city, it'll be a cheaper flight. But they're all the puddle jumpers that fly in the Midway. Like from the West Coast, you can't get a nonstop flight to Midway.
I'm gonna show you guys a photo here once I can find it. Albums. Pictures. So back in 2016 on this very field, a miracle occurred. I want you guys to look at this form. See that?
That's Millennium Park.
Is that Tony Romo? Oh, no, that's Diego. Look at that high release. Look at that. Look at that.
That's Millennium Park, right?
They call me the spinner because I can spin it.
Your shorts have some pockets.
It was 2016, Buckley. I want to see photos of Buckley from 2016 before you start making comments about my pocket.
Too many fucking pockets in your shorts.
wait, let me count them.
You have like 18 pockets in those shorts.
Yeah, no, I had a big old. All right, so I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. Well, 6 pockets. Come on,
a lot of pockets for a pair of shorts.
I know, but hey. You can't make a comment until we see the 2016 Buckley. with his Abercrombie and Fitch shirt. And...
Oh, I know. Oh, Abercrombie and Fitch.
So that park was designed by Frank Gehry. You know what it cost to build that park? The bean and all that?
The whole thing?
Yeah, the whole thing. Yes.
When was it built?
Shit, 15 years ago?
$1.
Back then, I'm going to say...
$600 million for that shit.
It's worth it, man. It's honestly, to me, Stuff like this, you don't realize how important it is until you don't have it. I'm going to show you guys.
Well, Rosa, Brody, let's be honest. It didn't cost $600 million. It cost $200 million, but there's so much corruption and contractors getting overpaid and people filling people's pockets that it wound up being six.
Correct.
So yeah. I'm sure you're familiar with this place, Buckley, the island, right?
What?
You're familiar with the island in New York City?
Oh, the man-made shit, yeah.
Yeah, so why? Give me street view.
What is this? I've never seen this before.
It's a new man-made island they made off of Chelsea.
Why can't I see a decent street view? Do they not want people to see this? Anyway, Brody, it's like a, I don't know, you can go there and have, why is everything at night? You can go there, you can have a drink, you can relax, whatever. And I was asking Tim, I was like, who built this? And he's like, the city. And I was like, well, who paid for it? And he's like, the taxpayers. And it was incredible. I mean, they have these beautiful, I mean, sounds lame, but the benches they have there, they're going to last 100 years. Like when they made this shit, they actually gave a fuck. Same with, I think it's called the High Line, right, Buckley?
Yeah. Well, the High Line was already there.
Let me find the High Line.
The High Line is train tracks that are out of commission, and they just threw a boardwalk over it.
Yeah, but they did a really, really, really good job.
Look, the work that they do.
Look at this shit. Look at that work on that concrete. It's fucking perfect.
You know, a lot of this stuff is union, and those guys don't fuck around.
Yeah, and so like when I see stuff like this, or when I see like that, like look at that. Look at that inlaid wood. When I see the park in Chicago, like, yeah, it's expensive, but the city is accessible to the common man. I don't know. We genuinely do not have this in Atlanta, stuff like this.
Well, anybody who lives on the Highland is not a common man.
That's true.
Whatever you call it.
Yeah. Bright Blues place is right.
That one right there, the top one.
This whole thing right here.
Well, the top floor is his. The bottom floor, he just stores pottery in.
Look at this building.
Oh,
yeah. So when I went there with Tim, Tim was blitzed out of his mind, and I'm looking around like, damn, Bright Blue, this fucking really nice place, and Tim's like, yo, this place is gay as shit. I'm like, what? He's like, I've never seen a gayer place in my life. I'm like, okay.
This is an expensive neighborhood.
Yeah. I would live here. If I won the Mega Millions, I would live here for sure. Let me show you the Atlanta Beltline.
I don't know if you pick along the High Line if you won the Mega Millions. There's a lot of better spots.
Let's see this. Satellite. So we have something sort of similar. Let me find this place. Small G, did you order the steroids that make you hard? That keep you hard?
No.
Where the fuck is this?
But I was just curious. Somebody... There's a, I don't know, there's like a injection for testosterone. Yeah. Is that all the, how do you know how much you need to inject by yourself or whatever?
Well, you're supposed to only have that if you get it prescribed by a doctor because your testosterone is low.
Right. And but there's a like store or something like you can go there and purchase.
No. Yeah, in Mexico you can do it, but not in the U.S.
I see.
It's very illegal, but it's not hard these days. Getting your prescription is like pretty easy. It's kind of scary, actually. See, you can get them over the phone.
Mm-hmm.
This is what we deal with in Atlanta. Look at this bullshit.
Oh, Diego. I can take you outside of Manhattan in 2 minutes. I will show you the worst maintenance you've ever seen in your whole life.
I get that, but Buckley, this is like, this is incompetence on the city. Like, they paid somebody to grass this. They grassed it and they walked away. And they're like, you didn't pay me to grass it twice. There's no topsoil here. I mean, it's just like, it's fucking
Diego, harsh. I have a feeling you're going to be kind of disappointed the next time you come to New York.
Why? Has it gotten bad?
It's getting pretty
bad. It's getting worse.
Pretty really? Bad out there. Yeah. It's, I was, we were there for the.
Fuck is this bullshit? Look at this crap.
I was there for the MJ meetup. And, the subway's dirty, right? But it's like, you know, it's not a fun place to be, but it's usually all right. This last time around, there is a homeless problem. I don't know if it, I mean, I don't want to get political, but there's a lot of immigration. And
I was going to say, is it the homeless thing, or is it people that are like
kind of everywhere? And it used to be like you get out of Penn Station and there's homeless and drug addicts, and then you walk a few blocks, there's like a little bit more, and then they kind of disappear.
Yeah.
Now every entrance to every subway, you got between 5 and 10 people begging. You got people walking in the train that are fucking scary. Like, there's scary fucking creatures down there walking around. Like, now we got yesterday a cop was shot, killed by a guy who was arrested 23 times, was let out 23 times, killed a cop. We have a guy that's running around Manhattan punching women in the face and recording it for fun. 5 girls today were punched in the face. It's just a fucking shithole.
Oh, but hold on a second. Hold on. So this guy apparently hasn't been caught, but I'm sure if I walked into a Best Buy and stole an iPhone, I'd have the FBI on my case, like tracking number, like everything. They'd be pinging the GPS to find me, but yeah. A guy filming punching people in the face and uploading it on fucking social media, they can't find him? Like, what?
They won't find him. Listen, there's a reason why the other day multiple people in the chat and the panel wanted to reach through the phone and fucking choked him until he couldn't breathe. You know, people wanted to murder him because New York has gone in a direction that if it goes like this continuously, right? In 5 years, it's going to be a city that is similar to what it was like in the 70s.
Damn.
I mean, it's not nice.
Is it a new mayor or what's going on? Like,
yeah, fucking mayor. He's
fat.
He's a
schmuck. But hold on. When I say new mayor, I mean like since I've been there. Like maybe not last October, but before it was fucking brilliant.
During COVID, they let a bunch of people out of Rikers. They let a bunch of people out of the mental institution because of COVID. Wait, right? They took away, I don't know when, but they took away, what is it, cash bail? I don't know. Yes. I might not be saying it right. And
we had the
marches in 2020 where a bunch of cops left and quit and body cams. And the criminals have taken over. Criminals have taken over, and cops don't want to show up because just like yesterday, guy gets pulled over. He's been arrested 23 times, let out 23 times, and yesterday was the day he decides to pull his gun and shoot a cop who was like 30, below 30. Killed him. 23 times. And it's just ridiculous. It's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, that's really fucked up. There's America says the crime situation is a choice. They want it to be this way. I don't know about the crime, but I definitely feel like the way you leave a city, like dilapidated, like me and the wife took a walk. We took a train to the middle of the city one day. We're like, oh, we're just going to walk the equivalent of our Fifth Avenue, right? We'll walk the whole thing. It's called Peachtree Street. We got off the train, and if somebody wanted to rip my kidneys out and take my watch and kill her, they could have, and nobody would stop it. We're talking blocks of, and not that these people are bad, but these people were on, I don't know if it's meth or crack, but you can just tell they're zombies, right?
Well, did you see my post on Instagram today?
Mm-mm.
There was someone in California who found I guess if someone got hit by a train and there was severed limbs.
Yeah.
This crackhead picked up the limb, went into the street, and started eating it.
What? Shit. Is it on your story? I don't see it.
Yeah, it was on my story, unless Instagram made me take it down.
They probably took it down.
I don't know. I get. I'm waiting for them to ban me because I just keep pushing the limit.
But like the point I'm making is like, you know, we spend money on all sorts of things, but they turn a blind eye to the most. Our Fifth Avenue is dilapidated to the point where nobody wants to be there, and because of that, nobody's renting the buildings, and because of that, I mean, it's just insane.
If you let the real estate go to shit, everything else does. There was this talk in the stream the other day about how developers are running the city. They're not. If they were running the city, they'd be filling the rents and everything would be nice. They'd be making money. People don't want to buy, invest, or do real estate in the city anymore because that's going to make it fall. It's the complete opposite. It's the fucking criminals have the keys to the city, not the billionaires at this point.
Wait, was this in LA, the lake, or was this in New York?
No, that was in California. We don't have that yet. We don't have cannibals.
Okay, I found it.
So, yeah, I know. I saw that. So, but America raises a pretty interesting point. Now, I'm usually not like into like wild sort of conspiracies or philosophies, but it is a head scratcher on why the people in charge allow this to continue, because they could stop it. It wasn't always this way, right?
Yeah, think about San Francisco.
They made policy decisions that prisons are too crowded, and so instead of building more prisons, we're just going to let more people out of prison. Well, what do you think is going to happen? No shit. I mean, so none of this is a surprise to anybody, but the question is, why? I mean, they know
they're shutting down the breakers.
Why?
Brody, they're shutting down Rikers Island.
Oh my God! Okay.
Do you think it's to make?
I mean, are they building anything?
I don't know what they're going to do, but it's on the table, and there's a plan that in the next 5 years they're trying to take out Rikers completely. Hmm. So,
and then going to your point earlier about you know when the real estate goes to shit, then it's over. And that's, you know, Diego talking about Fifth Street in Atlanta becoming, you know, not desirable anymore, you know, people abandoning buildings. So, you know, I think the philosophy that people will say something like, usually on the left, they'll say, listen, poverty causes crime. But no, crime causes poverty. This is how you end up with impoverished neighborhoods. You end up with impoverished neighborhoods because of high crime rates, businesses leave, and then buildings become, you know, just dilapidated and nobody comes in, nobody's going to come in and do anything to make it better. That's just the way it is.
So like this is Atlanta is comprised of like the downtown, the old downtown. We've got this midtown area up here. And then way up here, it's not even Atlanta. It's called Buckhead, way up here. So the actual downtown, it's essentially a no-go zone. This entire area south of my mouse is, for the most part, abandoned. I'm trying to show you guys where we were.
Is that where they filmed The Walking Dead because there was no people?
Pretty much, yeah. Yeah, like where is? Let me see where we are.
Yeah, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't even want to talk politics. I'm talking about what I actually see with my own eyes. It's not a political thing. It's like, this is what I'm actually finding out there. And New York City, like, let's put it this way. If you have a daughter, don't let her go to New York City by herself.
Yeah. So this is this is where we got off on the train. You have a really beautiful building here. I think it's boarded up. You have the train station, and then you start walking up this way, and it's like, you know, this whole fucking building is just empty. And then coming down to this part, this used to be like the hub. this entire row is empty. These buildings empty. Everything. This whole street could be like something amazing. You know, there could be restaurants everywhere, but nothing. Is this the David? No, this is a different David.
You guys want to talk? Thank God I will be here for 4 hours.
Oh,
by the way, how many packs of cigarettes do you think he finished just that one, you know, one episode? And I mean, my God, it's insane.
Let me just do the conversion here. David, $2.99 Australian. I think this might be my first Australian super chat. Equals $1.95. He says, thoughts on the 1406M as a one and done.
Fantastic one and done.
We're going to go to my source for pre-ceramics.
Except, as you know, Buckley, there's no such thing.
You know,
one and done is a unicorn.
You're right, but I am getting close to, I'm not going to say a one and done for life, but a one and done for a matter of months, if not years. I'm getting there.
No way.
I swear.
I think this, I mean, if you're going to buy a Rolex, personally, my only flaw with this watch is the bracelet's going to be a hollow end link. Everything else beyond that, it's perfect. You could definitely buy this watch and never look back.
Why not just get the modern no date? Or it's not, you don't think it's as perfect for some reason.
Are you talking about the like the ceramic ones?
Yeah, whatever. Yeah. I'm not
41.
The 41? Yeah. In my opinion, they don't have the same look. It's
no.
What was this? This is 904L steel. What do they use now? 316 or some shit? No, or is it
the other way around? That's okay. That's 316L, and now they use 904.
Yeah, it's got. I mean, I think Buckley's talked about it. I think Ashin's talked about it. It's got a completely different look. So, like, I think this guy has a ceramic sub on his page. Let me find it. Yeah. So here's a ceramic. We'll zoom in. Right. I mean, it doesn't look bad. It's not a bad looking watch. But then when we go to the pre-ceramic stuff, like a sub date, it's just different.
Yeah.
It's a little bit more cold. It's a little sharper, I feel like.
Smaller.
And that's the other thing, the size. Let me go back to the wrist shot. I think it's a better proportioned watch, personally. I don't know. What do you guys think? His question, though, is it a one and done?
Yeah, it is. It's a one and done.
Look at that.
It's a one and done. You know why? It's so, those watches are so much more comfortable than the modern ones.
Yeah, they are.
People are like, I want the solid 904L. Maybe you do, but honestly, have you put on the hollow? The hollow is way more comfortable.
There's the plus and minuses. I used to own a quote unquote pre-ceramic Explorer 1, and when the new ones came out, you know, when Rolex switched to ceramic and all that shit, I remember thinking like, yeah, you guys are fucking losers. Like, this is all bullshit. Rolex lost its soul, blah, blah, blah. And then when I got the new Explorer and I saw how strong the clasp was and how smooth everything was and how tight the tolerances were, I was like, oh shit. This new ceramic stuff is actually pretty good, but it's definitely different. I think it has its place.
Ooh, look at this. Weight of the old ones. You don't even feel it.
Yeah. Look at this. How much is he asking? 10 grand.
Diego, can you still find 1406Os that are unworn, brand new?
Yeah. Let me go to Chrono 24 really quick. So 1406O. And are you asking for the M or just any?
The M is the more modern
one. Modern, yeah.
Yeah, I guess the M.
Yeah. So you go here, you search it, you go to filters, condition, and then you go to unworn. 17 of them.
Not a lot.
And they're, let's see, load high.
Where I thought they'd be.
15, 17. I found a unworn sub date of this variant on Chrono for like 12.9. I was trying to message the guy and he never fucking answered me. I was gonna try to lowball him, but
so I don't buy pre-owned I try not to buy pre-owned watches because I don't like that somebody else wore it. Like, I don't want whatever is associated with them. I don't want that. Right?
Yeah.
So I've always thought about getting one of these, but I can never bring myself to pay fucking 20 grand.
So if you want to pay 20 grand, like, this is the guy. This is as close as you can get to quote unquote unworn without paying 15, 16. This one's definitely.
You know what the thing is about these watches that's so much better is, let's say you get a 1406LM unworn, right? The bracelet's perfect, no scratches, like literally unworn, right? Mm-hmm. You get to wear that watch and you get to patina age it. You get to age it. The ceramic, oh, yeah. There's no way to age it. It's done. Like, that has to stay the way it is forever, or it's going to look like shit. So one of my issues, like, I love the Sky Dweller, but one of my issues is that's not a watch you want to beat up. It's not going to look good beat up. You could buy a solid yellow gold, rose gold, white gold Daytona, beat the living shit out of it, because the bezel is the same metal. And because it has history and the size, it'll look cool beat up.
Yeah.
Right?
I agree. It's
Batman doesn't look good beat up.
No, it doesn't. Well, it doesn't, no. So when you see, like, you've seen Ryan Singer's Zenith Daytonas. They're scratched up, right?
Yeah.
You've seen his old Redline Submariner scratched to shit, but it looks really good. You do that to a new Daytona or a new sub, and you still have that beautiful, perfect ceramic bezel. It's like, oh, dude, did you drop your watch in a wood chipper? Like, what's going on?
Yeah, I mean, these.
I'd say
black sub. The pre-ceramic black sub is better. If you want a Pepsi, I think the new one is. I've had both. People forget I had both.
Yeah.
The new Pepsi is worlds apart from the Neo Vintage, because the colors were too much. The red and blue is too much.
Yeah.
The new one's better.
Well, I've always said, though, I mean, you can agree with this, that these ones that you've heard me say it, pre-ceramic watches have soul, if you will.
Yeah.
And they truly do. I mean, every one of these pre-ceramic Pepsis is going to be a completely different watch. It's going to be like really unique. You know, all these chamfers are cut by hand. Everyone is different. Bezel looks slightly different. I mean,
do they have the pre-ceramic bluesy unworn?
Yeah, that's going to be. Let me see this. What is that reference?
Like the code Pepsi, but the old
one's that 16613.
I don't know.
Yeah. So, and you want solid gold or?
No, I think I would like the two tone. I want to keep it. Oh, I got a lot. I didn't even know.
Yeah.
These colors are better. The new one, it's too light. I had it. And after a while, you're like, why is this so fucking light?
Yeah.
This thing, man, when this patinas, it's going to look so good.
These are some pretty bad photos. I see your super chat, by the way, OC91. We'll get to it in just a sec. Let me find a better example. This might be good.
It's cheaper. It's cheaper than the black.
And by the way, if you guys are wanting to buy pre-ceramic Rolex and you're concerned about polishing, just go to Chrono 24. search for the reference and filter by unworn, and you can actually like look at what's the bezel look like, how do the crown guard shapes look, all that stuff, and you can use that as a reference.
But here's the thing, right? If this is unworn and it's from 2009, the movement has never been activated, right? It's been, the movement's been sitting there for 15 years. But when you go to wind it, right, all the oil and all that, is that going to function, or is it going to explode? Like, how does that work?
So I got my grandpa's date just that was sitting in his closet for like 15 years, and it was fine. And the last time he had it serviced was 1972. So you probably are messing stuff up, but here's the thing, like whether your watch is unworn from 2009 and you get it running the first time, if you send it to Rolex, it's going to cost you, I think with the complication, it's 1200, maybe 900, right? So you're going to pay that $900. The alternative is wear the fucking thing until it dies, send it to Rolex and pay $900. Yeah, so I really wouldn't worry. It's not like these gears inside this date, this Submariner are like holy grail relics that must be preserved. Rolex has the parts to fix them. So
do you guys really like think that the stuff was unworn though for all that time?
That's my other question.
This is sticker. Yeah, it's still sticker.
How is it that you've had all of this stuff unworn for 15, 20 years? Just like, how is it even possible?
Like, let me show you this. 16500.
They're putting in the safe and forget it.
But why would someone do that back then? Like, I don't understand.
So, I mean, there's going to be collectors of things all the time, no matter how hot the market is. But some of these, like I've seen some stories where, and it might have been a Hodinkee video, I can't remember, but it was like some video where I think it was a gray market video. He's like, yeah, these guys came in the shop and they bought Submariners, one, the pre-ceramic Submariners, one for him, one for his son, and they just never took him out of the box. Fully stickered, perfect. You know, so like there are some fucking people like that in the world. Imagine, Buckley, if you're one of the Louis Vuitton guys' kids and someone gifts you a Submariner, you know, you're going to put that bitch in your closet and never look at it. You're not going to wear it. So
could be that. It's like so crazy to me that that's even.
Like with that Daytona, there's only 28. But if I take that off, there is 437.
That seems like a 28 seems like a lot.
It's worldwide though. 6 billion people on this planet, you know?
Yeah, okay. Let me say this. Hopefully I don't offend anybody. You have to have a flute bezel.
OC 91, $2. Is a smooth bezel with Jubilee for a date just a bad idea?
Yeah.
So, OC, are you talking current Rolex or are you talking like modern? Let's go to the Rolex website. I don't know if you could pull off a smooth with Jubilee.
People do it. I think you got to have the full works. You have to have Jubilee, you have to have fluted.
Are we going 41, I guess? So Buckley doesn't get upset. All right, let's see. We'll do steel.
No, you can't do that.
You're going two-tone? Let's start with steel.
Who's going two-tone? He's going two-tone?
Oh, no, you said you can't do that when I was picking steel.
No, I mean, like, you really got to have, you got to have flutes.
I don't know. Doesn't look terrible.
It doesn't look terrible. It's a Rolex. No Rolex looks terrible, but
fucking that's what happens when you try to zoom on the website.
If you're gonna do it, you gotta. If you're gonna do it and you're asking, the answer is fluted Jubilee.
Let's look at the blue. Let's look at this one up close.
The Biden.
This is the Biden.
You got to pick the fucking Biden. Why'd you do that?
Is this not the Biden?
That is the Biden.
Okay. Well, he is our president. I got a coworker. He comes to my office every day. Your fucking president's fucking up again. I'm like, my president? He's like, yeah, your president.
I like the smooth bezel. I'll be honest. I feel like it's a little more versatile as a daily to me. I mean, you know, I don't know. The fluted gives it sort of a more elegant look for higher occasions. Oh, I don't know.
He's saying silver dial. Let's do that real quick.
Start. Yeah, I like the smooth bezel too.
So when I heard the rumors that you could order any steel Datejust you wanted, I was like, huh, watch this. I'm going to order the Palm Fronds. And I ended up getting it. The configuration I chose was smooth with oyster. So I'm not opposed to smooth. Okay, there's the silver. Let's blow this bitch up real quick. Yeah, that's not too bad. I don't know if I like the blue better, but
yeah, this is going to sound. I feel like with the silver dial, I would like the fluted much better. With the blue, I think the fluted looks actually better for more formal occasions. But I think for a daily, I like the smooth.
Yeah.
All right, it should only come fluted, Jubilee, and you wear that bitch. How you know who wore a fluted Jubilee, Diego? Twin Silver? You know who wore one?
Hold on. Is someone I know?
Oh, yeah. I'm sure you're a big fan.
Patrick Bateman? I don't know.
Ronald Reagan.
Oh. Yeah. Old Reagan. Let me see. I'm building it with the fluted now for comparison.
You're not sharing the screen.
I know. It's a surprise. Boom. Ooh, I don't know. That's too much.
No.
No, that looks better than the smooth with the silver, I think.
What?
But not necessarily with the blue. You
guys are smoking crack. I think it's too much. I think there's too much going on there.
No.
Put that bitch on an oyster bracelet.
No. That's even worse.
Osama wore a smooth bezel. All right. I guess smooth bezels are out. See, even Kino, I like the smooth. The fluted is too flashy. I think the fluted on oyster is the perfect mix of flashy.
No, and buy an OP. If you want the oyster, buy an OP.
Let's see. I don't know, but yeah, I. My opinion, OC, would be go for the, if you want to do smooth with oyster, or I'm sorry, smooth with Jubilee, the darker dials work better than the silver.
Yeah.
That's black, my opinion.
Black looks good.
Yeah.
But you gotta, if you have the choice, you gotta go full works. That's the date test. And by the way, the Jubilee bracelet is the most comfortable bracelet maybe ever. Don't go oyster.
David says, honest opinion on the IWC Mark 20 black with brace. What does with brace mean?
Really bracelet.
Oh, okay.
And bracelet instead of the strap.
You want my honest? I don't know if he wants honesty. Do people actually want that passport?
I thought with brace was like a walking brace. I don't know. All right, let me find this thing. View, is it a pilot's watch, I guess?
Yeah.
Let's see.
It's the non-chrono, though.
The VF41.
Is that there it?
There it is. These are big crowns.
No, those are big dial. Oh.
That's the big pilot, not the Mark 20.
Pilot, okay.
You would think the Mark 20 would be up top. Here we go.
There you go.
20 black with bracelet.
Yeah, there you go. That's it.
So I still don't understand why they have Hitler's plane on the back. I don't understand. And the plane that carried the Fallschirmjäger to Italy and Poland. I don't understand. I know why. They have their own. IWC has their own plane, but it's a funny joke. I don't know. I mean,
most people would go for the blue dial because I think the blue dial is better, but it depends if you want to have a more toned down look or not.
I like the black dial more than the blue. Personally. This is like, I don't know. This is a sick watch. And how much?
I would get this watch for whatever reason they're 43 millimeters. They make with an open case bag, but not the 40s. I don't know why.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, they should show off the movement a little bit. That's all I'm saying. I don't get it.
Would you guys get it on a bracelet though?
Their bracelet is pretty good.
I would almost always get a watch on the bracelet and then buy the scratch.
Right.
Yeah, because this has this is quick strap strap. Was it bracelet quick strap?
I'm gonna shift this. If you're gonna get an IWC on a bracelet, you really should go for the Ingenieur and get it at a discount.
Interesting.
The Ingenieur is a nice watch. I've tried it on. I've tried on the white one, the black one.
That is true. You won't
pay retail, but that is a much better watch on a bracelet than the.
And I'd say go with the black.
You could probably get the black one. I want to say $9,500, $9,000, right?
I'll get a discount.
Yeah, a discount. That's like what is that, 20%, 15%? But this is a much better watch.
I was surprised by this watch. You know, we all went and looked at it, and I don't know, put it in my hand. I was like, huh, was not expecting that.
Yeah, better than you thought, right?
Damn, 11.7 though.
It's too much. You shouldn't be charging that much, but I think like $7,000-$8,000. This is a great watch.
I wonder what these are going for. I'm crying.
It's a great watch. Like 10.5. They're going for like 10.5.
You've been looking.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to buy one, but I'm thinking if you're going to get a black dial,
traditional.
If you're going to get a black dial IWC on a bracelet, go with the Ingenieur.
Okay, these are all the old ones. Let me filter. So what is the Ingenieur competing with right now?
A Datejust.
Datejust, what else? I put the Datejust is like its own thing.
The Datejust this is
competing
is better,
with.
But this is competing with like, there's not a whole lot in that price point. I mean, if you like it, the Octo from Bulgari, or the other one, the Roma from Bulgari, is, you have the Santos, you have. What else is there?
Speedmaster.
No, that's a Chrono.
Pretty soon, this is going to be competing with the Overseas.
But you know what? The best version of one of these watches.
Sorry, Brody.
What's that?
I said, pretty soon, this is going to be competing with the Overseas.
That's right. The other watch is the Zenith Pilot Watch. If you're looking for a Pilot Watch, but I don't think that one comes on a bracelet. No, those are both black cases too, I think. No, maybe I'm wrong about that. I could be wrong.
Yeah.
Poor David. He's asking about the Mark 20.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is this might. I mean, arguably is a better watch. I'm not going to say it is or it isn't, but the Pilot, he's looking for a specific kind of, he likes the pilot watch look.
Yeah. David, how big are your wrists? Let me ask you that question. Cause that's going to dictate what I tell you next.
I actually like the Mark 20 is better on the strap than the bracelet. I think.
I agree. Yeah. 1,000%. It's cheaper too. 5,250. Yeah.
The problem for me, and this is going to sound so, I mean, it's Twatty Tuesday, right? You notice that it's Twatty Tuesday. So it's going to sound very twatty. If it's not a Rolex bracelet at this point, I'm not interested.
Yeah, it's a compromise.
It's a compromise.
Unless it's like Patek level or maybe even, I mean, obviously AP and Vacheron, but everything else, it's a
Vacheron. Vacheron, if I owned one, it would be on rubber like 24/7.
Yeah, it's a compromise.
That Agenor's got a very Nautilus type bracelet on it.
Yeah,
they do.
So here's the thing with the Agenor bracelet is like, or not, yeah, it's great. But then, I don't know if you guys can see, you get into the detail of like, to me, this looks disgusting. All these holes on it.
Yeah, they made the pins. They made them too big.
It looks
horrible. They should have been smaller.
Look at that. Look how it plays with the light. It's disgusting.
It probably makes the bracelet more sturdy, but.
It does, but to me, this to me is a cheap look. When your watch has, when you can pretty much take every link out, I don't know why it cheapens the look.
Yeah, and they did make an awful lot of them too. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, look at that. Many. It's like
fun. You're right. They did way too many.
I probably need them all, but that's my fear. I was looking at what website? I was looking at European watch company. And they had a, you know, Boston's 5980. And I'm like, what if I get one of these and there's not enough links to take out? Like, I'm fucked. Johnson EDC is a spreadsheet whore. $2. Thank you, Johnson. Let's see how much we've raised so far.
Do you guys see the Odysseus bracelet?
The Odysseus?
Yeah, it looks very similar like the IWC's. I think they probably use the same manufacturer.
Damn. Oh, look, I'll pull that up in a sec. $177.40 so far. Thank you, guys.
I hate the Odysseus.
Yeah, it looks awful, but
I don't like it.
Odysseus, that's Lange?
Yeah.
That's the only Lange sale over retail.
Let's see what happens if I search. You guys can't see what I'm typing. Lange and Zune.
Yeah, I don't get the frenzy over that watch. Does anybody know anybody who owns one? I don't know anybody.
Lange's?
No,
or Odysseus.
Yeah, the Odysseus.
I personally don't. I know a guy that has. I think he's bought two Lange's, and he's asked for a Zeitwerk and an Odysseus is what he's wanting next.
And just Lange in general is not like, I mean, of all the unboxings and of all the watches that I've been exposed to over the last year on Tim's channel, and I can't recall a single Lange.
They had their moment. Like they had like a 2 or 3 month period where people couldn't get Pateks, people couldn't get Vacherons, people couldn't get AP.
Yeah.
And they were kind of just like, all right, what's next? And I think Lange got inundated all of a sudden by a bunch of people that were like, all right, I need something. And they ran out of watches, obviously, because how many do they make a year? Was it 2,000, 9,000?
Right.
Yeah. You always know the production numbers, Buckley. How many does Lange make?
Not a lot. I think it's
like, I think like 5,000.
Yeah. So imagine you have a global population of people that are all of a sudden into watches, right? And they can't get the top brands. They're going to go to Lange. These guys got inundated. They're out of watches. So then when people started going, hey, Zeitwerk, that's a fucking 2 year wait. What? Yeah, sorry. And then, so there was a period where these watches, whether right or wrong, were going significantly over retail.
Yeah.
But that quickly faded, and I think that's part of the reason you don't see too many people unboxing. But also, they don't make a lot, right? Yeah,
I think the 1815s are awesome. The Chronos, I think
1815 Chrono probably the best. Yeah.
Yeah, they're 78 grand.
Get it?
Yeah, these are sick.
So what I say the bracelet for Odysseus is the same as IWC because everything on that bracelet is similar. The adjustment, the Michael adjustment.
Oh yeah, they use the same
thing, and then the also thing, yeah. The way they took out the link, it's the same. They look at the it's very. They need to use the tool to punch the hole there.
Yeah.
No. The you see the hole on the back.
Right
that,
here.
Yeah. That no, not that. Not that.
These tool. Ones.
Yes, that's the okay. way they release the links. So weird, longer use the same manufacturers.
They, if you want to see like the bargain of the century, I think it's Lange Perpetual. It's going to be these. Let me open up this article. You can find these for like 50 grand all day. And I think they're 38. Look at that. Like, would you rather buy a Calatrava at your 80 for 40, or would you rather get this for 50?
No, this is a way better watch.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
My only gripe with this watch is the rotor. If we can get to the back of it. Well, actually, no, it's a micro rotor, so it's not that bad.
It's sort of a large micro rotor, but it's cool.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a shame when, you know, some of these watchmakers that have like all this finishing and beautiful, they put like a huge half moon rotor on the back.
Yeah.
Like when I got my Patek, you know, all I ever heard people talking about was, oh, the movement, blah, 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 the finishing. And I flipped it over and I'm like, shit, I can't even see. Okay. I got to watch over to look at the rest of it. Like, it was kind of somewhat of a disappointment, but
you still can find this in 50 grand. I don't think so.
Oh yeah, watch this. Lange Perpetual. Sort load high. Here's one for 43, 44. Here's one. This one's platinum.
Wow.
For 31. Okay, so this is the watch that a long time ago, Double D, he was like, hey, my guy at Watchbox called me. You know, he's got this watch for 55. I want to do it. Now it's 34 or 31.
Good thing he didn't do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but 31, that's a deal.
31 is the auction.
Platinum.
But look at the rest of them are like, so why is this one 31? And the others are like,
that's the auction. That's starting price.
Oh, okay. Got it.
Ah, don't ruin it, Smolty. Jesus Christ. All right, here's one. What is this one? It doesn't say. This might be platinum as well. 52. Good. And that's right. Chrono price, right? So you buy this.
Would you rather get Aquanaut this?
Oh my God. You're talking about gray market price?
Yeah.
I'd rather have this than an Aquanaut.
I think so.
I think if you put both of them in front of you at the table and you say, you're giving me 50 grand, which one are you taking? It'd be really hard to take the Aquanaut.
But
it'd be really hard.
No, the Aquanaut, it's easy to get your 50 grand back.
That's true. Yeah. You buy this and you're fucked. Yeah. Platinum. It's insane. Looks good on the wrist too. Buckley, you ever heard of let me get off watches real quick. Vinch. You ever heard of the story of Arnold and Jesse Ventura on the set of Predator?
Probably.
So someone told Jesse Ventura that Arnold's biceps were like, I don't know, 36 inches or some shit. And Jesse Ventura's like, oh, I've got a fucking 38 inch bicep. And so they knew that there was like this big, you know, they're both big guys. They're fucking going at it at the gym. So Arnold told the guy, tell him my bicep's only 36 inch. So Jesse Ventura goes in the gym and he bets Arnold, like, I don't know if it was 10 grand or like, I bet you 10 grand my biceps are bigger than yours. And Arnold's like, go for it. They measure. Jesse comes in at 38. Arnold's like a 42 or some shit.
Oh my god.
It was like some interview with, I think it was Arnold telling the story. It was pretty good.
That, you know, he smokes cigars on that set nonstop.
Who, Arnold?
Yeah, he's got like a real cigar fucking addiction. Like, it's not a show. It's not like, he's like a 2 to 3 a day guy.
You've seen the video where he talks about, let me see if I can find it. Let's see. He's talking about putting tequila on his cigars.
Yeah.
Hold on. There's another video that I want to see first. This video is incredible. All right. Let me share this tab. Might have to share with audio. All right.
He's a heavy cigar guy.
Vic, the way I got into smoking stogies is very simple. I went home with Maria in 1977 when I met her at the tennis tournament. I went home with her to meet her parents in Hyannisport. And there, her father, after dinner,
he's got a steel cigar,
lit it up. Then he gave one to his son, then to the other son, and to some other people. And he said to me, "Do you want a cigar?" And I said, "I don't know how to smoke a cigar." He says, "Well, try it, because after dinner, everyone ought to have a cigar." So I tried it. Well, the rest is history. I'm still smoking stogies. I love it. And he introduced me to something really good. And I know now the next question. Knowing you, being the interviewer that you are, digging in deep all the time, you will say now, what does your wife think about that? Let me ask you something. When my wife's father has introduced me to stogies, what is she going to say? She's not going to say my father made a mistake, because her father never makes a mistake. So therefore, it is okay. I can smoke stogies around her. I can smoke stogies in my house. First of all, because her father introduced me to stogies. And second of all, because I'm a stud. I don't take no shit from anyone. I smoke my stogie anywhere I want. I don't have to find a hideout place like you.
That guy is just.
Oh my god! I don't have to.
Well, maybe if Maria put her foot down on the cigars, he would have felt like he could do other things. Oh,
Jesus Christ! I don't have to find a hideout like you. We need to show that to Sean. No, Sean smokes inside, right? Yeah, he smokes in his home. No, because I remember Sean saying, like, in LA, there's like only like a couple places you can actually go and smoke.
Yeah, the forest fire is a real problem there.
Jesus.
Dude, have I seen Pumping Iron? I could fucking recite it.
Who's asking? Pumping Iron? I've never seen it.
Oh.
Let me see this.
Diego, you've never seen Pumping Iron?
Should I?
Oh my god, immediately.
How is this going to change my life? Tell me.
It will change your fucking life. What do you mean?
Like, what daily changes am I going to make after watching this?
You'll finally understand.
Understand what?
You'll stop doing push-ups and you'll be benching.
Oh, jeez. Dude, you realize my gym at a maximum probably has like 150 in weights.
Yeah, you got to get out of there. Listen. Oh, I can't believe you've never seen Pumping Iron. That is dude.
Make a reminder on my phone.
That's the
most. Remind me this weekend to watch Pumping Iron.
That's the most perfect upper body, I think, ever.
Arnold?
Dude, look at that. Dude, look at that shot. The one on the right. No. But you just had it. The one where he's sitting.
This one?
Dude.
Oh, that one.
No. You just had it.
All right, I was here.
Yeah, that.
I scroll down.
That.
All right. Let me make this bigger. Guys, there's no shame in looking at a Arnold. No,
dude, that's why he was the king. Try and beat that. No one will ever beat that.
No. His son's trying to. You've seen pictures of his son?
Yeah, he won't beat that. No one will ever beat that. Ever.
Have you seen Arnold when he was a little kid?
Yeah, it's funny.
son kind of looks stupid. I wonder how he used to talk when he was a kid. Yeah, I want to move to America.
Well, you know about his dad, right?
Oh, his dad was
a
part of the Axis forces.
Yeah.
Did you guys ever see Bill Burr's bit on Arnold?
Mm-mm. What does he say?
About, you know, people are giving him a hard time. You know, he was a great man. Yeah, he did the bad thing. You know, it was in the wake of him, you know, getting exposed for sleeping with the nanny or whatever. He did a bad thing, but think about what he did. You know, he said, listen, I'm gonna become the world's best bodybuilder, and he did it. And he's doing it in this like Arnold Schwarzenegger
Arnold voice. Yeah.
Like, then I'm gonna move to California. I'm gonna become a famous actor. And he couldn't even speak English. He became the biggest action star. And then he said, I'm gonna be governor, and he did it. It's just, and it's, but it's filled with his comedy, so it's really good.
Yeah.
It's hilarious. I mean, if you think about what he accomplished, it's pretty amazing.
Hell yeah, man.
Diego, you need to see Pumping Iron like as soon as possible.
Let's watch the what's it called?
I don't know if there was Troy back then. I don't know if they had that.
If they had what?
Like trailer promotions? I don't know if they had that back then. Oh, this is a great scene.
Just go until he's dead. I guess he's not dead.
Dude, that fucking is so insane.
We're gonna get made. If Curly's watching, we're fucked.
No. Curly would understand.
Diego and Smolty watch this together.
No, Curly would understand.
Blood is rushing into your muscles, and that's what we call the pump.
You must get a tight feeling,
like your skin is going to explode any minute. You
know, your skin is going to explode any minute.
Into your muscle, it just blows up, and it feels different. It feels fantastic.
Dude, you have to watch this movie.
How much weight is that?
Having sex with, I don't know, 30 pounds maybe?
So can you believe how much I am in heaven? I'm like getting the feeling of coming in the gym. I'm getting the feeling of coming at home. I'm getting the feeling of coming backstage when I pump up. When I pose out in front of 5,000 people, I get the same feeling. So I'm coming day and night. I mean, it's terrific, right?
Dude. All right, I'll watch it.
So yeah, Diego, they go heavy, but they don't go as heavy as you think they go. It's really also a matter of what's referred to as time under tension.
Yeah.
Like how much time you hold, like eccentric movements and holding movements and moving slowly and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Looking glass, like what the fuck? Hey, man.
You need to see it.
I'll watch it. You know what? Let me think. I'm trying to think of my work schedule, how it's looking. Is it something I can watch in the background, if you think?
Kind of.
Okay.
It's a documentary. It's like one of the first documentaries ever.
Hell yeah. I'm going to watch that. I'm going to start pumping iron. It's going to get huge. I definitely, you know what? I miss this era of Arnold, though. The fucking Rambo and Predator. You know one of his best movies?
True Lies. Yeah.
True fucking Lies.
Yeah.
Takes this guy out on the joyride.
Yeah.
Bill Paxton.
R.I.P.
Dude, did you ever see Commando?
Yeah. Dude, all right. So Commando is... This is in a category of movies that I've seen, but I was also like 10.
You got to see it again.
So I gotta watch it again for sure. That scene when he's on the beach and he's like, let me see. There's a fucking image. Of course, now it looks like I'm gay. I'm talking about the part where he's like suiting up. This one.
Oh, and he draws the black on his face as if that's going to do anything.
Yeah. Maybe we can find that. Hold on. This might be the shortest lived.
Dude, it has one of the greatest It has one of the greatest film mistakes ever. Do you know about
that?
How
does this work? Do I have to pause this every 2 seconds? Yeah, he's...
Do you know about the film mistake? You don't remember it. Brody, you've seen the movie, right?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
There's a huge mistake they made.
Dude, we're gonna get
and it's in the movie forever. So, you remember the scene where he's chasing the guy in the Porsche?
Uh-huh.
They bash up the side of the Porsche, right?
Yeah.
When he gets in the Porsche and drives it away, the Porsche perfectly fine.
Yeah.
Perfectly fine.
Why has he got an AK?
He's a fucking commando, dude. Leave him alone.
I tell you what, though. All this stuff, I know it's like funny. It actually has, I mean, the real purpose is it breaks out the lines because the human mind or the human brain is designed to recognize faces, right?
Yeah.
So when you start breaking up, like all my buddies at Hunt, we were talking about this and they're like, you could be 10 feet from a deer. You won't see it until it moves. Like,
right.
It's a real thing.
Do you know
why you guys want to watch this commando? Look at that.
Do you know why he made commando? Because Sly made Rambo.
Oh, dude. Was that his, like, payback?
Yeah, they hated each other for, like, 20 years.
Dude. Wait, so what was the mistake in the movie?
So type in Commando Porsche scene. No. Oh, no. Not that. Oh, okay. So skip movie clip. Go to the movie clip. No, back. See the movie clip? Click that.
Yeah.
Right now, skip to the end. No, not that far. You got too far. Look right there. He's going to push the car over, right? Watch. Okay. Watch.
Don't tell me it changes colors.
No. What? Just watch. Right? The car's all bashed in.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's all fucked up. Oh, dude, it's really fucked up.
Yeah. Well, back then, nobody cared about these cars. Okay, and he pulls away. And...
Perfect. No, oh, my God.
That's funny.
Hold on. Dude, I gotta
there's also the scene in True Lies where the guy shoots in the bathroom and he has 10,000 bullets in the gun.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's true in like almost every movie, man.
So I still can't believe where's Miami Vice? I can't believe Buckley has not seen Miami Vice.
I've seen clips, but like it's so outdated.
Dude, this is like, I don't know if I can play any music. This is the fucking show.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah.
Dude, it's so sick.
I feel like you listen to this music when you drive the Corvette.
Look at that. This is Mathis's world. But look at the... in all seriousness, though, the filming. Look how they're filming this chase scene.
Yeah.
Dude.
Because it was... this was Michael Mann, right?
Yeah.
And... You could just see that it's Michael Mann's cinematography. It's totally his style.
And he's driving. Fucking epic.
Oh, right on there.
Yeah.
Look at that. Shit. Yeah, it's a great show.
There's a bush under there, though, so.
Hey, man. This is when he gets his Testarossa. I still haven't learned how to do that. The burnout. I feel like I'll make my engine explode if I do. At a minimum, you got to watch the pilot. It's like an hour and a half long.
Have you seen Have you seen Red Heat?
Mm-mm.
Red Heat's another Arnold. Oh, dude, Red Heat. He plays a Russian, like, cop or whatever.
Oh.
Dude, this is such a good movie. Have you never seen Red Heat?
Red Heat? No.
Dude, yeah. You gotta watch this too.
Red Heat. What the fuck?
Well, what's great about it is it's with Jim Belushi and he's hilarious in it.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Arnold, fucking True Lies.
Oh, the True Lies bathroom scene with the million bullets.
This is the best though.
Oh yeah, you're fired.
You're fired. You're fired.
Guy hanging on like a cartoon character.
So stupid. So stupid. Where's the bathroom scene? Let's see. Small G, when are you selling me your Elegante?
You gotta skip a couple. You gotta skip pretty far. Yeah. Right now. Look.
Does he keep shooting?
No, no, just watch. Watch when he shoots the thing. Look at all the bullets.
I was gonna say that was about 30. Oh, you're talking about on the
right here. Look, he shoots the doors and there's like 500 bullets in the gun. Watch.
All right, yeah, because that's only 30 rounds.
Yeah, well, he'd already be out.
Oh, he's got double mag stack.
Yeah, but you gotta. Look, he's still not out of ammo.
No. Someone's gonna teach me how this works. I guess we're commentating.
Those little AK-74s are so cool.
Oh, timeout. Look at this. They just stuck these bullet holes on with tape. You see that?
Yeah.
Hollywood fucking magic. That's hilarious. Oh shit.
Oh my god. Non-stop bullets. Non-stop bullets.
Of course, Arnold probably runs out after like six rounds. Oh dude, this guy's got like...
He's got like 500 rounds. Oh, now we reload. Okay.
What about Kindergarten Cop?
I'm not a huge fan of that movie.
What?
No, never been a huge fan of that movie.
Great movie. Remember this kid? What does he say?
Boys have a penis, girls have a
vagina. Girls have
a
yeah. Oh, I saw this scene like the other day randomly on TV. They fucked him up. That was a good scene. Mm-mm. Man. Yeah, I do burnouts in my underwear. That's true. Gotta change them out. All right, well, it is midnight here. We got work tomorrow morning.
Yeah, I'm only awake because I took pre-workout and I'm fucking bugging out.
When did you take it?
I took it at 4 o'clock.
Yeah, I take mine at like 6 every day.
Yeah, but then you work out, right?
Yeah, that's when I get home. Buckley just takes it just to take it.
That's what I'm saying. Buckley, you just took it and you didn't work out and you didn't like...
No, I did. I did. It's just too strong. This is a new one. It's too strong.
What is it?
It's called Rise. And I'm definitely... I have risen.
Who's this guy, by the way? I recognize him.
That's Frank Colombo. Or not Frank Colombo. Okay, so whatever... that's not Frank Colombo, whatever is...
Franco Colombo. He was his...
Franco Colombo, right.
Yeah. Dude, yeah. All right. He's
Italian.
I'm going to try to go for his physique. I don't think I can get Arnold, but I can definitely do this.
Dude, you got to start eating. You got to put on weight.
Dude, he looks like his width. What the fuck?
Yeah, he was 185 pounds at 5'6".
How is he so thick?
Because fucking genetics and steroids, baby.
So he was doing steroids too?
All of them were.
But even with steroids, you got to eat to put on size. You got to eat a lot of calories.
Diego, are you aware of Tom Platz, the leg king?
Oh, that guy's thighs are insane. His quads are insane.
Yeah, he's got the craziest legs ever.
Shit.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
This is so crazy.
Yeah, we're definitely getting made fun of tomorrow. That's okay.
Look at his legs.
Oh, man. Look at the food.
Yeah.
What in the world?
Yeah.
At what point? And here's the thing: this dude's looking in the mirror, and he's probably like, "My calves are tiny. I really don't. I need to work on my calves."
He used to. He would squat for every workout.
Jesus. That's like fucking Olympic bicycle level times two.
It's too much. It's way too much.
Jesus
Christ. Way too much.
And you think the judges see this and are like, oh, okay, you win. Like,
no, he never won.
No, because they care about proportionality.
That's what I was going to say. Like, the dude looks like a frog. Like, literally, this dude looks like a frog.
Mike Mensur had the best physique besides Arnold.
If you told, what is it? A chat GPT, like, paint me a man, a bodybuilder on a frog's legs. Like, Mike who?
Mike Mensur. Outside of Arnold, Mike Mensur had the best physique.
Mike Mensur. Oh, yeah, mustache dude. Yeah, pretty jacked. I'm guessing he's steroids also.
I mean, yeah, all of them.
Who's the guy that's in those memes?
Ronnie Coleman.
Ronnie, yeah. Is it Ronnie Coleman?
Probably. Lightweight baby.
Ronnie was huge.
No. I mean, Ronnie Coleman's lightweight baby.
Look at his back in that picture right there.
That's disgusting. That's
insane.
That freaks me out because you can like see his spinal cord.
Yeah,
I don't like that.
He was big, man.
It's this guy. The don't hurt me one. What's this guy's name?
Oh, this guy's such a fucking asshole. I hate this guy.
Is he an asshole, though? Michael Hearn?
Yeah, Michael Hearn. He claims that he's natural, and everybody knows he's not, and he's just a fucking liar.
Michael Hearn. I don't know, man.
No, I know.
You don't think that's natty?
No, he's 56 years old. He's not natural.
Genetics?
No.
Why don't we Google bodybuilders before steroids? Let's see what that's like.
I fucking hate Michael Hearn.
Dude, these guys look fucking weird. Look at Jesus Christ.
They look pretty good though. I mean,
that dude is almost naked. Yeah, they just look like they're
shredded.
What about who's that weird bodybuilder with like the tattoos and like the contact eyes?
Well, he's dead.
Yeah, what was his name?
Rich Piana.
Rich Piana. Yeah, that dude.
He's dead.
Yeah. Apparently, this dude is doing meth.
Yeah, Holy crap.
They
crazy drugs.
That guy is huge.
He didn't drink. He said he didn't drink because he's like, the calories, I don't want to fuck up with the calories and the sugars or some shit.
His arms aren't real. They're synthol.
Dude, yeah.
Synthol. You know that, right?
Synthol. I always thought that they were a little strangely proportioned.
What do you say they are?
Synthol. Synthol is an oil that you inject, and it just makes the area bigger. It's not.
Oh, gross.
Horrible.
Look at these guys.
I know. Some of these guys look just absolutely weird. What is synthol? So these guys do the synthol, and that's what you get.
That's Photoshop.
Oh, my sure. God.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's got to be.
Yeah, dude. And it's always like, these weird dudes in Russia.
That guy? Yeah. Looks at that for why this Russian bodybuilder.
What the fuck?
Oh man, that's just weird looking. It's so weird looking.
Yeah, synthol's fucked up.
I always wondered how they got that look. All right, now I know.
Oh my god.
Let's end the stream on a low note. Ugh. Let's end the stream on a low note and look at shit that we'll never get.
You might get it. If anyone's going to get it, you're going to get it.
Who knows? That'd be such a bitch if they're like, hey, your Nautilus came. Are you serious? Are you sure it's this one?
You think that you're going to get made fun of if Carly sees it? I just named every bodybuilder with a biography right off the right off the tongue. I'm going to be the one that gets killed in the comments.
Yeah, but no, because Carly's going to be like, oh, Buckley, you know, he takes care of himself. He knows, but it's me, the world's Jacob pulling up these guys. Look at him zoom in on his crotch. Shit's funny. Yeah, so they offered me that Daytona, was it yesterday or the day before? on Oyster Flex, and I said no. And then I ended the conversation with the picture of this. Mm-hmm. She didn't reply. But I'm standing my fucking ground.
That's okay. I wrote the essay that I met with a week and a half ago at AP House. Like a really nice note, really nice email. No response.
Yeah.
Nothing. Not even like, hey, great to meet you. Nothing.
Zero. I would even take this, dude. You want to hear something fucked up? When this watch got announced and introduced, mm-hmm. they asked me about it. They said, "What do you think about the 5811?" And you know what I said?
Something stupid.
I said it's too big. Why did they make it bigger?
Fucking idiot.
They're like, "What?" And like, I said, "It's where's the size?"
It's 41.
Like, yeah, they made it a 41. I don't want it. And they're like,
"Jabroni,
it would fit." And I'm like,
"Jabroni."
I'm like, "Nah, it's too big."
It's literally, it's almost
Diego. One millimeter.
And then I tried it on at Watches and Wonders, and I was like, "This is a really nice watch, man. Congrats." it's sick, but it's also $70,000.
Oh, dude, yeah,
that's a lot of money. I'd rather get.
It's a lot of money for a three-hander.
I'd rather get that, but you know the problem with this watch. Well, not really a problem. It's got the old clasp.
Yeah, I have it. It's not a problem.
You know, they don't have a picture of it, but. It's not a problem until you look at the 5726 that has, do they have a photo of it? Why don't they show a photo? They're not going to show a photo, but it's got the new, that micro extension stuff.
Mm. Yeah. Micro extensions always a nice,
it's loss. For a watch like this, to me, it's huge because
yeah.
If you put this watch on and you're like between links, you know, you're spending that much money on a watch and it's either too loose or too tight. Like
if you're a tweener on a double folding clasp without micro extension, it sucks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
All right. Well, I'm going to bed. Good night.
I'm going to bed too.
Later, Buckley. All right, guys.
Good night, guys.
Good night.
See you later.
Bye bye.
There, guys.
Bye-bye. All right, guys. Thank you for watching. We're going to go and say thank you to the Super Chatters. OC and I don't want the first one. Brody. And then America dropped a nuclear bomb on everybody. Really appreciate that. Daniel Katz. Twice. Very thankful for that. Kino Pravda. Logan Hall. I don't remember how to say it. Lada Sensei, maybe? Thank you very much. We had Looking Glass, Vimal, the legend, the OG, Daniel Katz again. Don't spend your lottery winnings just yet, Daniel. You still got to win. Vimal again. And then David with some interesting watch questions. Appreciate those. Hope you got your answers. OC91 again. David and then Johnson EDC. And another reminder, I think in total we raised $177.40 the two streams before because of Rose's match. We were at $267.96, so donated that today. We'll probably do one or two more streams. We'll see how high we can get this batch, and we'll send that on over. All these super chats, again, go to a family that is in need, and I eat the 30% Google fee, so I'm doing my part too. Thanks for watching, guys, and we will see you at some other time. I don't have a schedule, obviously. The wife is sick right now, so kind of had a reason, not a reason, but an avenue for escape. So maybe on the weekends, but hit the notification bell, that way when we do stream, you guys see it coming, and I'll try to schedule them with a little bit of advance notice as well. Anyways, thanks again, everybody, and we'll talk to you later.